Ideal's Robot Commando is here to help you. He's your one-man army. No enemy can destroy him. He fights off tanks, hurls missiles one after another. Even a squadron of planes can't stop him. Robot Commando fires his secret weapon. He takes orders from no one except you.
Forward!
Ideal's Robot Commando is battery operated to obey your command. Adjust the control, speak into the microphone.
Left! Fire!
Ideal's Robot Commando is here to help you. Look for your Robot Commando. He's looking for you.
Calling all kids.
Be on the lookout for the season's most wanted toy, DX Getaway Chase Game. The good guys chase the bad guys at scale speeds up to 60 miles an hour.
Wanted for action.
Two battery-powered cars, almost 24 feet of road, five getaway routes controlled by remote switches, 41 colorful, easy-to-assemble buildings and accessories.
Wanted for excitement.
Excitement found only in the thrill of a chase as you try to catch up or get away.
Wanted by everyone.
DX Getaway Chase Game, only at DX service stations. DX Getaway Chase Game, just $4.98 with 8-gallon purchase. Hurry while the supply lasts. At participating DX dealers. Another special value from Sunray DX, the oil company known by the customers we keep.
The Dick Tracy Show!
Tracy to kids, Tracy to kids, come in kids, come in kids. It's here at last, the new Dick Tracy two-way wrist radio that keeps you in constant touch with your buddies. Easy to work, up antenna, switch on, press talk button, and you broadcast from room to room, and even house to house. No wires needed, yet voices travel back and forth. Radio on the open road from one bike to another, or when out hiking.
Dad, Dad, I found a bear's cave.
Be right down, son.
The powerful, fully transistorized Dick Tracy two-way wrist radio is a real electronic instrument.
Make sure all the fellows get their A-OK Dick Tracy wrist radio so they can keep in touch. Over and out.
The one and only Dick Tracy wrist radio, wherever American toys are sold.
Okay, Chief. I'll get on it right away.
Calling Joe Jitsu aboard SS Purline.
Come in, please.
Two jewel thieves, Paris and Mole, are on your ship. They have $1 million black pearls stolen from the Maharaja of Mysore.
Your job, recover pearl, arrest thieves. That is all. 6-2 and even. Over and out.
Tracy is following us. We must get rid of Joe Jitsu, quick.
Yeah, or that silly snooper will spoil our caper.
Suspects do not suspect, I suspect. Ha-ha! So can carry out search without difficulty.
Oh, yeah? You'll make a tasty dish for a big fish.
Hurry, get rid of him.
Okay, boss.
Oh, so sorry. Cannot oblige. So sorry. Excuse, please. So sorry. Have little suggestion to make. When cried with raw, good policy to have accident policy. Ha-ha. Sayonara, and hombre suggest same apply to Paris.
I will deal with you, Monsieur Jitsu.
Oh, no rough stuff, please. Oh, so sorry. Excuse, please. Oh, so sorry. Excuse, please. Hand are slipping.
Did anyone get the number of that truck? Now I hurry your rickety sprit to stateroom of culprits and sryery search same.
Not after I drop the boom on you, Shorty, like so. Oh!
Excuse, please, but soft head needing hard share. Here our cabin. Also, here at the footsteps approaching. Had better hide. Quick, Maul, the satchel.
Don't worry, it was right where we hid it.
Open it. Also, hello. Observe, please. Priceless black pearl found reposing in satchel. So, most happy to place you under arrest.
Come on, let me have it.
Hold it, please. Jiu-Jitsu calling Dick Tracy.
Come in, Joe.
Happy to report. Have situation under control.
Good work, Joe.
6-2 and even. Over and out.
Come on, let me have it.
Most happy to oblige.
Oh, so sorry. Excuse, please. So sorry.
Reach for searing, please. I have the drop on you now.
But not now. Fool. Netwit. No one outwit Paris. No more of your tricky tricks, Jitsu. Toss me that pearl.
Oops. Also, a butterfinger.
Oh, no. No. Oh, mon Dieu. Oh, son of a bitch. Come back, my little beauty.
Fortunate to catch escaping pearl.
Ah. Stop, thief. I will fix you.
Oh, no. No. Hey.
So sorry. Hurry. Also, they are coming at me again. Are glutton for punishment.
Grab him, Mool.
Are you? Jiu-Jitsu calling Dick Tracy.
Go ahead, Joe.
Happy to announce have recovered a black pearl and placed two crooks in crink.
Good work, Joe. I'll send the copter out to fly you into headquarters.
And Joe, that pearl is dangerous. Don't tell anyone where you're carrying it.
Oh, no. Top secret. I keep it under my hat.
Start your day a little bit better.
I gotta have some of that sugar crisp. Welcome, Doc. What can I do for you? I'm all ears.
I'm hunting that ornery rabbit.
You mean the one who takes your sugar crisp because they're made of whole wheat to help make him strong?
That's the long-eared varmint.
Haven't seen him.
Tarnation! Give me back my sugar crisp.
Breakfast, Sam.
Well, if you can't beat 'em,
get the muscles of whole wheat with Post Sugar Crisp. For breakfast, it's dandy. Or eat it like candy. Sugar Crisp!
Start your day a little bit better. Get the treat with a strength of wheat. Crisp from Post.
It's Mattel's official Beanie and Diesel Beanie Copter.
Wind it up. Put it on. Pull the cord. It's a Beanie Copter. Watch it fly in the sky.
It's a Beanie Copter.
Beanie Copter.
Wind it up, put it on. It's the only official Beanie Copter. Comes with two copter blades.
You can tell it's Mattel. It's swell.
It's landed. Ideal's new astro base has just landed. Look, the space lock is opening. And here comes the astronaut. He's being lowered from the astro base into the remote control scout car. The two space probes are being mounted for launching. The car is scanning the area. And there go the space probes. They're calling them back to the astro base. Mission accomplished. Ideal's astro base and Colonel McCauley's space helmet are the greatest way to play outer space. You can scan the skies, launch deep space probes, fire rockets, destroy stray meteorites. Ideal's astro base is at your favorite toy store. Get your Ideal astro base today.
Okay, Chief, I'll get on it right away. Tracy calling Hemlock Holmes. Calling Hemlock Holmes.
Go ahead, Tracy.
A robbery at Eastside Westside National Bank. Bandits identified as BBIs and Flat Top. Call the retouchables and bring them in.
Yes, sir. Calling car 13.
Calling the retouchables.
Proceed to Eastside Westside National Bank. Robbery in progress.
Let's go! I say, whoa, stop, you chaps. Wait for me. Hold everything. Whoa, stop. Oh, please, stop.
Got the door. Let's blow.
Okay, we escort with the load. Ha!
Go get him! After him! That way, there!
Hey, BBIs! The police! The police!
Get after him! Come on! Get out of the
way! Yeah, we're being tailed. My name ain't BBIs.
I'd blast him.
Nah, we'll give him the slap, Sam. We'll lose him on this highway interchange.
Stop in the name of the law.
After him!
Hold it, Flat Top. We're chasing the cops.
Turn around, you fool. They're on our tail.
After those crooks, men. Halt or we fire.
Ha ha! They missed us.
Yo! There go the crooks! Quick, turn around! There they go! Hey, watch it! We're coming together!
Look, BBIs, how are we going to get these policemen off our backs?
Don't worry, I've got a little plan. Hey, copper, you got a phone call.
A phone call for me?
Yeah, some dame named Judy.
Judy, Judy, Judy! Wow! Hello?
I don't particularly care for policemen, but this cop's good for laughs.
That's right. He ought to be on TV.
After them, men.
Oh, watch it, you guys.
Break the law, will you?
Hold it. Hemlock Holmes calling Dick Tracy.
Go ahead, Hemlock.
I've got him cornered, Tracy. It's only a matter of minutes now. Roger, Dodger. Over and out.
It's a good thing this guy's bow-legged.
Hold it, boys. We've got Hemlock. There go the crooks.
Go, go, go. Give it the gas.
Follow that car. We've got him on the run, men.
Hold on. Wait, you chaps! Hold on, I say! Whoa! Stop!
We'll take a shortcut to the hideout. These stumps in the old cow pasture will stump them.
I say, driver, watch out for the stumps, will you? You blithering idiot, look out! On your blooming pins, men! After them! We're right on top of them!
BBIs, give it the gas, you fool!
I gotta slow down. A truck's blocking the road.
Oh, no. Look out. The cops are going to club our rear end.
Don't worry, Hemlock. We're right behind you.
All right. Let them have it.
There's something fishy in here.
All right, you two. You're going to the station house on the double.
We've captured them, sir. Nothing to it. Just like shooting fish in a barrel.
Good work, Hemlock. And since that case was so easy, I'll give you a tough one next time.
Me and my big mouth.
Hey.
house sure is quiet early in the morning. Till they hear that. Raring to go, because breakfast roundup starts with great tasting Tang. Nice and icy from the refrigerator. The best flavor this side of Dodge. Naturally, there's some people who just ain't satisfied with only one glass of Tang. Should have waited for nightfall. Must be the new natural orange flavor that gets them so rambunctious. What a way to start off the day.
Hey, that's my Tang.
Them's fighting words, mister.
Drink Tang, gang. It's Tangerific.
Hi, Sylvester.
So what's new, Bugsy boy?
Well, there's this new postman who likes new golden alphabets.
Everybody likes alphabets.
What this postman doesn't like is dogs chasing him.
Dogs?
Here comes the postman now. I wonder what'll happen this time.
Hi there. I'm your friendly postman, and I mean post. All the letters I deliver are post alphabets. New golden alphabets. Now they're brown sugar frosted. And that's what's new about new golden alphabets. Brown sugar makes these crispy letters made with oats golden and taste better than ever. Start your day a little bit better. Wait a minute there, nice doggy. I'm not the kind of a postman you fellas chase. All my letters are new golden alphabets. The only cereal with all letters. The one that's brown sugar frosted. Thanks, kid. Why don't you pick up some of those new golden alphabets? You'll be so happy about the whole thing.
Hercules, hero of song and story, Hercules, winner of ancient glory, fighting for the right, fighting with his might, with the strength of 10 ordinary men. Hercules, people are safe when near him. Hercules, only the evil fear him. Softness in his eyes, iron in his thighs, virtue in his heart, fire in every part of the mighty Hercules.
All right, now, how does a train go? Now, an ocean liner? Now then, how does your tricycle sound? I see. But how would you like your tricycle to sound? Well, you can make it roar with Mattel's terrific new Varum hot rodder engine. Put it on a trike like this, or like this. You get your own special key. Start it like Dad's key starts his car. The remote control is up here where it belongs. Sounds like a real engine. Bike or almost anything that moves. Mattel's new Varum hot rodder engine. You can tell it's Mattel. This one.
Now, for every kid who has ever seen a science fiction movie, thrilled to the amazing strength of an out-of-this-world movie monster, comes Great Garlou by Marx. Garlou the Mighty. Garlou the Untamed. Garlou the Terrible. Who can stop him? Who can control this monstrous creature? You can, kids, because Great Garlou by Marx is yours to command. With these battery-operated controls, you can make Garlou go, stop, bend, pick up, turn. Yes, Great Garlou, almost 2 feet tall, will be your faithful servant. You name it, you're the boss. Bring out-of-this-world excitement into your house, kids. Own the most fantastic toy of all. Great Garlou by Marx.
M-A-R-X spells Marx, world's largest toy maker.
Castle. In his chambers, young King Dorian prepares to affix the royal seal to an official document.
Now, Minotaur is in the castle!
Minotaur?
Minotaur!
royal seal.
Aye, Dorian. And without the royal seal, no king may rule Caladan.
So it was you, Daedalus, who set the Minotaur upon me.
Aye, and it will cost you a king's ransom to get back your seal.
At this moment, a familiar figure approaches Caladan on a visit. It is the mighty Hercules!
Look, Herc! Look! The Minotaur! The Minotaur! It's got the royal seal! Just stop it! Just stop it!
I will, Newton.
Nice work!
Where'd the Minotaur go, Newton?
I can tell you. Into my endless maze, where no man who entered ever came out. Care to follow it, Hercules?
No, Herc, no!
I'm not afraid.
Farewell, Hercules. We'll never see you again.
Careful, Newton. This maze is filled with traps.
Yay! What got us, Herc? What got us?
The petals of the Pegasus plant. No power on Earth can pry them loose.
Then we're trapped here forever. Forever?
Afraid so, Newton. But wait. There's one chance. Newton, don't let this roof touch the ground or the plant will spring to life again. Come on, we've got to find that Minotaur.
What's that?
It's the deadly cocoon of Cletus.
What if it hits us? Us?
We'd better not let it.
We just can't keep dugging forever, forever.
A plant of Pegasus. Throw it.
What would you do without me, Herc? Just what would you do without me?
Sometimes I wonder, Newton.
The Minotaur! Come on!
The Royal Seal! The Royal Seal!
Get the seal, Newton, and follow me. This Minotaur is the only one who knows the way out of this maze.
The Royal Seal. It's Newton.
That's me.
Did you get it all by yourself?
Well, I had a little help from
Olympia.
Who are the toucans?
Those funny little birds.
The baby birds.
From Kellogg's Fruit Loops. Tommy, it's your turn to tell what to do.
Let's just let them play for a while.
What about the Fruit Loops?
Shh, we're too busy.
We better get Toucan Sam to help us. Sam! Toucan Sam! Sam, we'd like a bowl of your cereal.
Of Fruit Loops. Now we'll have those crisp cereal circles that taste like fruit.
And go crunch the boot.
Sparkling with a good shade. It'll dry up your muscles, May. Made with real fruit, Everflay. Ooch, fray, oops, fray.
There's breakfast.
Not sponsor.
That's right, sisters. Strikingly similar, and with many similar items on their grocery lists, including Kellogg's cereals. But this sister shops just for two, herself and her husband. So her breakfast assortment is Kellogg's Request Pack, the adult assortment. Four different kinds: Corn Flakes, Rice Krispies, Special K, and 40% Bran Flakes. Six individual servings, the assortment adults requested. On the other hand, her sister wants a wider choice. Her assortment is Kellogg's Variety Pack. Eight different cereals, 10 individual servings. Sweetened and unsweetened cereals a family with children wants. For a variety of ages, you'll like Variety Pack. For adults only, you'll probably choose Request Pack. Your best choice either way.
Kellogg's best deal.
In the cave of Daedalus, the cunning wizard mixes a mysterious brew.
Now, Dido, a pinch of earth from the Lernian forest. No, no, Dido, this is not for cats. Wait here, little friend. I must go now and test the brew. You will do fine. It works. It works. The brew has given me the strength of a thousand men. Now, to put my strength to good use. So you have no money, eh? I'll teach you to lie to me.
Mount Olympus, home of the mighty Hercules, the grim scene is observed by the seer Dodonus on his crystal rock.
You must stop Daedalus, Hercules, but take care. So long as his feet touch the Lernian soil, his great strength increases.
So does mine, Dodonus, when I put on my magic ring. Let's go, Newton.
That's me.
And so to the Lernian forest hurtles the mighty Hercules to meet the challenge of his archenemy.
Whoop. There he is.
Yes, here I am, the new master of Lerna. And if you value your life, Hercules, you'll clear off.
I'll take my chances, Daedalus.
So will I.
Come right ahead. Another sample of my new strength, Hercules.
Who are you, Herc? Where are you?
You'll have to do better than that, Daedalus.
That I will.
We must get that wizard's feet off the ground so he'll lose his strength.
It'll take more than you, Hercules.
Understand, Newton?
I got it.
Daedalus!
Defying me again, Hercules? You won't get off so easily this time.
hunt me down.
I will, Daedalus, once we're out of this forest.
Yeah!
Join us at his side, standing there with pride. Victory is here, raise a mighty cheer at the side of Hercules.
Unusual weapon. It is specially designed for counter-espionage, for Agent Zero M. It's called the Zero M Sonic Blaster. This is why. It fires a massive blast of compressed air, and this tremendous roar is the actual sound. For training purposes, this special delayed action target comes with it. Mattel's powerful Zero-M Sonic Blaster, wherever toys are sold. Remember the password, Zero-M.
A, B, C, Delicious, E, F, G. Gee, I'm crazy about post-alphabets. H,
I was robbed! Officer, somebody robbed my post-alphabets. I believe it was that crazy wabbit, Bugs Bunny.
Describe the goods, Doc.
Well, Post Alphabets is the only cereal with all the letters of the alphabet. They're made with real oats to make you strong and full of energy, and sugar sparkle to taste just a little bit better.
You mean alphabet spell energy from A to Z with a capital E. Oh, gee, these letters happen to be just a little bit better.
Crazy wabbit.
They're A, B, C, delicious. E, get them quick like a bunny.
Up the fenders while parking my rolls. Come and join me in watching movies of four great heroes, played by yours truly. A terrific bit of typecasting. Oh, Magoo, you're too much. Oh, operator, you can start the film rolling anytime now. Oh, thank you. Take your coats off and make yourselves comfortable, everybody. We're rolling, as they say in showbiz.
Wake up in the morning, there's a snap around the place. Wake up in the morning, there's a crackle in your face. Wake up in the morning, there's a pop that really says, Rice Krispies to you, and you. Pour on the milk and listen to the slam that says it's nice. Pour on the milk and listen to the crackle of that rice. Get up in the morning to the pop that says it's rice. Hear them talking crisp, Rice Krispies.
Barbie's giving a surprise party in her new dream house. The guest of honor is Mattel's exciting new teenage doll. It's Ken's buddy, Alan. Alan is exactly the same size as Ken, so he can wear all Ken's handsome outfits, the way Midge wears Barbie's fabulous clothes. And Alan shares wonderful adventures with Barbie and her friends. Saturdays, he works at the soda fountain along with Ken. And later, Alan and Midge double date with Ken and Barbie. Sometimes, when the weather's nice, they all go skin diving. Or they go on a picnic in the country. You'll love choosing outfits for Alan and Ken to go along with the ones for Barbie and Midge. You can get Mattel's new Alan along with the genuine Barbie, Ken, Midge, and Skipper wherever toys are sold. You can tell they're Mattel. They're swell.
No. You, steady, Magoo. Steady. Yeah, you're right on target. Oh, hello there. Yeah, I tell you, it's bad enough having to learn lines when you're an actor. Now I have to be an athlete, too. Ah, there it goes. Fast and straight, right to the mark. Oh, by George, what a beautiful cluster. Every arrow smack in the bullseye. Yeah. Oh, it's a good thing William Tell and I are such excellent marksmen. As you know, he was forced by an evil oppressor to shoot an apple off his son's head. Ah, what a terrible man. You won't believe the things that he does. No. Oh, but I'm getting carried away. If I don't stop talking, I'll tell you the whole story. And if I don't stop eating our most important prop, we won't have a program. Oh, this apple is so good. Oh, it's so tasty.
Switzerland, in the year 1307. Invading armies overran the peaceful countryside. Looting, murdering, burning, leaving utter devastation in their wake. And when the tyrant had fully conquered, he sent forth agents well-schooled in the arts of brutality to see that the people remained servile.
Fools, are you trying to kill me?
Sorry, Your Excellency, but the men are doing their best. The road is bad.
Just like the stupid Swiss. Well, I shall make them pay heavily for every moment of my discomfort.
Meanwhile, in a peaceful mountain pasture, one man, oblivious to the situation, happily tended his flocks.
So, little snowflake, is that what my singing does to you? Very well then, my little friend. No more singing, I promise you. And you stay out of trouble, or else I will never have Walter's bow and arrows finished by the time he gets here.
Yo-ho! William Tell! Where are you?
Hello! Here I am!
Oh, William!
Oh, yourself, Father Furze. Oh, this is a pleasant surprise. Walter will be here soon with our lunch, and you will stay and share it with us, hmm?
No, William, I am in a great hurry. There are things happening. I have come to tell you that there is to be a meeting tonight on the Rutli.
Father, your memory. Have you forgotten that this is Walter's, your grandson's birthday? Tonight, we will all celebrate at my chalet.
This is more important.
Could anything be more important than my son's birthday?
Yes, your son's life. Do you know that at this very moment, the tyrant Gessler is marching into Altdorf? Have you heard of this man?
I have heard.
This beast is being sent into our midst by our neighbor, the Emperor, to govern us. Is this what you want for your son?
Anything is better than the useless shedding of blood. I have seen enough of it. I want no part of your uprising. We must try to negotiate.
I've always known, William, that you were a dreamer and an idealist. But I never thought that you were a fool.
Father first. Yeah, but you will come and bid a happy birthday to your grandson, in spite of his terrible father, hmm?
I feel sorry for you, William Tell. But I feel sorrier for poor little Walter. It will be difficult for him to learn that his father is as stubborn as the goats he tends.
Oh, there. There, there, my little ones. I am sure that no offense was meant to you. Yeah, well, oh, enough of that. Walter will be here with the lunch at any moment, and I have not yet finished his birthday present.
Butley, you wicked little rascal. When will you be old enough to learn some manners? I know. You are jealous because it is my birthday and not yours.
Someone will die for this. I swear it on His Majesty's life.
Are you soldiers? Real soldiers?
I am Captain Sigmund Heinz of the Royal Army of His Supreme Majesty, the Emperor.
I am Walter Tell, son of William Tell. I am 9 years old today. And this is Butley. He is most often very friendly, but you have frightened him, and so he sits. He always sits when he is frightened.
You will take your goat and move to the side of the road so that we may move on.
What is happening here? Who is responsible for this? Is this the reason for our sudden stop?
Yes, Excellency. You see...
I see nothing but a peasant boy and a filthy goat.
I am Walter Tell, son of William Tell, freeman of Uri. And Butley is not a filthy goat.
Oh, a Swiss patriot, eh? Well, do you know what Gessler does with Swiss patriots? He takes his sword...
If you do, you had better answer to my father. He is William Tell, the strongest, the bravest, and the greatest marksman in all of Uri.
So, your father is this greater marksman. Well, if this is the case, I'd better not harm you, eh? Then perhaps it had better be your goat. What say you, men? Will he not make a tasty morsel on the spit for our dinner?
Let him go. Let him go at once, do you hear me?
Your Excellency, we have some distance to go yet, and it grows late.
Very well, then. This beast has far too little meat on its bones anyway. As for you, my fine young patriot, I am anxious to meet your father. Tell him that I have great interest in the greatest marksman in all of Uri.
Oh, it is a fine bow, Snowflake. And little Walter will be so pleased. Oh, where is he? What could take him so long? Walter, my son, what is it? Where have you been? What happened?
Oh, Father, look at poor little Butley. There were soldiers and...
Now, I'm sure he'll be all right. Oh, there's nothing wrong with your wicked little goat. See for yourself. There you are. Now tell me, son, what is it?
Oh, Father, there were soldiers and horses. And see what they did to our lunch.
Oh, so that is a reason for my son's tears? He fears that his poor father might perish of starvation?
But, Father, he was such a terrible man. He was going to...
Now, it was a simple accident. Of that I am certain. Come now, and dry those silly tears. Hmm? That's better. Don't you know that it is bad luck to weep on your birthday?
It is?
Also, it is apt to be very bad luck to try and aim a bow and arrow when one's eyes are clouded over.
Father! Oh, Father, you do have my bow and arrows.
I said no such thing, son. I simply...
You did. You do. Oh, say you do, please.
Yes, here you are, then.
Oh, it's beautiful, Father. Oh, I'm the happiest boy in all of Ori.
Hold on, my son. Now first, you must promise it never with this bow and these arrows will you draw the blood of any living creature.
I give you my word, Father.
Very well, then. I suggest that we declare a holiday and go home. Perhaps there will still be time to get in some target practice before dark.
Ooh. Hold! Hold there, I say!
Oh, Grandfather, I hope that you were not struck by one of my arrows.
If I was not, boy, it most certainly was not because of the excellence of your marksmanship.
I have just begun to learn.
It is a painful time, I know. But you must hold your head high, always. A Swiss patriot has reason to hold his head high.
Is it a good thing to be a Swiss patriot?
It is the finest thing to be, Walter. Well worth dying for.
Dying, Grandfather?
But not on your 9th birthday, grandson. May it be a happy one.
Oh, thank you, Grandfather. Thank you. It's beautiful.
I hope that your mother will like it as well as you.
Oh, Father First. Oh, welcome, welcome.
William, daughter.
Come in, Father.
Oh, so you have come to help celebrate the birthday of your grandson after all.
No, William. I have come to see if you might not change your mind and join your countrymen. Will you come with me to the meeting on the Rutli?
No, Father First. I am sorry, but I am not yet convinced that your way is the right way, or the only way. All it can mean is more bloodshed.
William may be right, Father.
Right? Can it be right to look the other way while your country perishes?
I love my country, Father First, and I love it well enough to save it from a bloodbath. I still think it is possible to negotiate.
Negotiate with throats? Very well, William. Go your own way. But bear this in mind, you will go alone.
Grandfather, why are you leaving? The other guests will be arriving very soon now.
I am afraid, Walter, that there will be no other guests.
Is it true, Father? Will our friends not come?
Oh, but certainly they will come. Certainly. Do friends desert one another for difference of opinion, son? No.
You've all met Mattel's famous Barbie, Ken, Midge, and Alan. But you haven't met Skipper. She's Barbie's little sister, and she has beautiful long hair you can really brush. And because Mattel's exciting new Skipper is smaller than Barbie, she has her very own fabulous fashion. They're all just as perfectly made as Barbie's. Skipper loves to go everywhere with Barbie, like rehearsing for the ballet. They go skating along with Ken. Skipper even has her own masquerade costume for the carnival. That's Barbie and Ken, and that's Skipper. You'll love brushing her beautiful long hair. You can get Mattel's new Skipper and her fabulous new fashions wherever toys are sold. And this tag tells you it's the genuine Skipper, Barbie's little sister. You can tell she's Mattel. She's swell.
This is my mother. She carries bundles, takes off boots, and changes diapers. Boy, does she go. And you know, I help her. I lend her my Cheerios. The way she runs around the house, she needs them. If you think Cheerios are kid stuff, watch Mom. She loves them. Give your mom go. But watch out. You might get kissed.
Big G, little O. Go with the goodness of Cheerios.
Now that we are all gathered, let us begin. We have gathered here united because we have had our fill of cruelty and oppression.
we would throw off the yoke of foreign rule, be done with the robbing, the burning, the slaughter. Done with it!
Yay!
We will be free men again, and those who are not with us are not our brothers.
Right,
And now, the oath. We, the free men of Uri, do this night solemnly swear to unite as one force, to plan and to execute an uprising, to shake from our shoulders forever the tyrannical yoke of foreign rule. So help us God.
So help us God.
Am I so wrong, Gretchen? Tell me that I am wrong, and I will go post-haste to the meeting on Nerutli.
It matters not what I believe, or what my father, or any of the others believe. It is you, William. Your heart must tell you what is right, and you must obey it.
And you do not believe that I am a fool or a coward?
Never that, William.
Then why are we so glum? Why must we depend on others to celebrate our son's birthday? Come, let us have a smile and a happy word. Come, it is your birthday. Any friend, our home and our hospitality awaits. The guest of honor has arrived, and the festivities may commence. Eat until you burst, because tomorrow you will need your strength for a trip to town.
A trip to town? Did you hear that? We are going to town.
And now, let there be music and dancing. It's the very best day in a very good year, and the very best time for the very best year, and the very best wishes are so very, very dear to a happy, happy birthday, boy. Oh, happy birthday. Not bad for peasant cooking, eh?
No, it's good.
We may be able to civilize them yet. To our beloved emperor, long may he live and long may he rule over the beloved fatherland and the Swiss.
Yay! Yay!
Who goes?
An informer, Excellency.
Well, what is it?
Tonight, Excellency, I know not where, a meeting was held, a secret meeting of the freemen of Switzerland, to plot an uprising against the Emperor.
Indeed. It was a secret meeting. You know not where. Do you know who attended this meeting?
No, Excellency, I know not.
I am surrounded by stupidity. Well, I shall conquer them before they conquer me, and I shall find out who the troublemakers are. Captain!
At your service, Excellency!
Tomorrow, you will see that a pole is set up in the square of the marketplace. On this pole shall be hung my hat. The emblem of the Emperor's power, a herald shall proclaim to one and all that to fail to bow down to this symbol will be punishable by death.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear all ye people of the Canton of Uri. Be it known that from this day hence, all must bow down to this hat as the symbol of imperial supremacy. Be it further known that he who dares to defy this order shall be put to death.
Spread the word. No one is to pass through the market square at Altdorf.
Spread the word. No one is to pass through the market square at Altdorf.
Spread the word.
Spread the word.
Spread the word.
Spread the word.
Oh, the marketplace is strangely deserted for this time of day. Well, no matter. My old friend Mother Bergendorf is here with her delicious apples. Shall we pay her a visit?
Yes, Father.
Well, Mother Bergendorf, and how are you this fine day?
No, Butley.
William, take care.
There, Mother. I try to teach my children good manners, but Butley is a little thief. However, I will insist that he pay you. And it's well worth the price. Yeah.
Hold! By the official order of His Excellency Herr Gessler, Viceroy to His Exalted Majesty the Emperor, you are under arrest.
Oh, but there must be some mistake. I have done nothing unlawful, unless it is now unlawful to purchase apples in a public marketplace.
Silence, traitor! You have failed to bow to the hat on yon pole. The penalty for your defiance is death.
No! No!
Never fear, my son. It is a mistake. We will explain to the Viceroy that we knew nothing of this new edict. Well, 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 what have we here?
A traitor to our beloved Emperor, Excellency.
You must let me explain, sire.
He failed to bow to the hat, Excellency.
But I saw no hat. I knew nothing of the edict.
So, you knew nothing. A fanciful tale.
It is the truth. My father always speaks the truth.
Well, now, what is this? Have we not met before? Oh, but of course, the boy on the road, the brave little fellow with a remarkable father, the greatest marksman in all of Uri, William Tell.
Well, I am William Tell, but my supposed reputation, I fear, is nothing more than a loving son's exaggeration.
The modesty of you simple mountain people. Did you not tell the truth about your father's great reputation as a marksman?
Oh, yes, indeed I did. My father is the finest marksman in all of Ori.
Oh, very well then. We shall see. We shall have a real test for a great marksman. Oh, yes. A difficult target. Yes. You shall be free on one condition only. The target shall be this apple at a distance of 150 paces. Placed on your son's head.
No, no, no. Put me to death if you will. But do not ask me to place the life of my son in jeopardy.
Certainly this is not an exhibition that should prove difficult for the great marksman William Tell. Or would you prefer that my soldiers test their skill?
Spread the word. They have Tell. Protect the boy. Get your weapon.
Please, Father. I am not afraid. You can do it.
No, I will not. I cannot. What if the boy should move? What if my hand should tremble?
Shoot, Father. Shoot.
No, my son.
Shoot, coward. If you do not, my soldiers will.
The time is here, Swiss patriots.
Yay! Great shot!
Silence, you fool! Well, William Tell, that second arrow, what did you mean to do with that?
If so much as a hair of my child's head had been harmed, Viceroy Gessler, that arrow would have found its way straight to your heart.
Insolent peasant, you dare to threaten the crown? Seize him and bind him to the tree. He shall be executed here and now.
Down with the Emperor!
A toast to the free men of Switzerland.
To the free men!
How about one to the birthday boy?
No, to the birthday boy's father, the bravest man I have ever known.
And the finest marksman.
Yay! Speech! Speech!
My family and my very, very good friends, I can only say that I'm a very lucky man. I have all of you here with me, and we have our freedom. What more could a man ask for?
Yay! Yay! Yay!
tomorrow and for all the tomorrows to come. I hope that we can all return to tending our flocks and living our lives in peace. And meanwhile, I think we should go back to celebrating the birthday of my son.
Sit down, Bond. Here, your 007 ring.
It leaves the 007 seal.
Your 007 ID bracelet conceals ammunition and message pellets for use with the 007 pen.
An ordinary pen, isn't it?
It writes like one, but it projects messages over 20 feet.
Ingenious.
And should you find yourself trapped, you merely whistle for help. Then by placing ammunition in that slot. Careful, Bond! This is vapor paper. Writing messages to our agents. Drop it in water.
Astonishing.
Good luck, Bond. You're on your own.
Get your 007 secret agent pen and disappearing vapor paper separately or packaged with a 007 secret agent ring and ID bracelet. You'll get a bang out of it. By American Character.
Captain Crunch presents Breakfast on the Guppy.
Morning already, Sea Dog. Where's the crew?
All hands on deck! Pirates off the port bow! This ought to fetch him. It's Captain Crunch, the cereal named after me. Captain Crunch, delightfully sweet, sugar sweet, and fun to munch because it keeps its crunch. So crisp, it never uncrunches, not even in milk. Now,
anybody for a bowl of Captain Crunch?
Scuttle my hornpipe, Sea Dog. There's people at breakfast I never saw before. Oh, man's got to be careful when he says Captain Crunch. Now it's your grocer's, Cap'n Crunch, the cereal that's named after me.
Oh, Magoo, you've done it again.
Tell me that score again, Charlie.
76 to nothing, Bloss.
Oh, what a day for our side. Ah, yes, sir. Golden memories.
Oh, Magoo, you've done it again.
Barbie, you're beautiful. Here's what we mean. Now you've become our fashion queen.
Here's Mattel's new fashion queen Barbie doll. And here's what's new. She comes with three beautiful wigs. Now you can change her hair color and style as easily as you can change her costume. The wigs are in the latest style. Bubble on Bubble, Slip, and Page Boy in lots of different colors. One is perfect for a casual outfit, the most formal occasion, or the most carefree Barbie fashion. You'll love mixing and matching Barbie's costume with her new fashion wigs. Look for the genuine Mattel Fashion Queen Barbie tag. Now there's the new Fashion Queen Barbie and the famous Familiar Barbie. The Barbie costumes you buy fit them both. You can tell it's Mattel.
Thank you.
wheel. Run 'em, race 'em, steer 'em too. 12 exciting models. The bodies are interchangeable. All you need is one chassis and one motor. Snap on a motor. Snap on a body. Switch on and...
go! Go! Go!
You can buy chassis, motor, and separate bodies, each under a dollar. Or buy a gift pack. Own them all. They're wonderful. They're ideal.
Who will be next to launch man in space?
Me!
And so can you with Deluxe Man in Space Set. You get a rocket launcher, defense base, and three different nose cones. Up goes the astronaut to the top of the launcher. The gantry moves in. The space capsule is locked on the mighty Atlas rocket. Blast off! There he goes! Man in space! Enemy bombers approaching. Flash the alert. Open fire!
Deluxe Man in Space, complete with missile base. With astronaut and satellite, you send them into flight. 3, 2, 1, fire! Deluxe Man in Space.
Wow, what a toy! Deluxe Man in Space is sold only at food markets.
Yogi, what's a home?
Where the
buffaloes roam, where the monkeys and hippos all play. Hey, I smell smoke.
Really? I didn't think our singing was so hot.
Hey, what's going on down there, So-So?
What do you know? It's a wagon train around the campfire. I wonder where they're headed.
You think we'll ever get to California, Major?
I don't know. Here comes our scout. Ask him if he's seen any engines.
Ouch!
Never mind. Engines!
Oh, they're being attacked by Redskins.
Lucky we're up here.
Yup. Looks like we won't be for long. We've been punctured. Quick, the repair kit, So-So. Grab a patch and start patching the puncture.
Puncture all patched, Peter. That ought to hold it. We're still falling. Man the pumps.
I'm manning, man. I'm manning. Lucky we didn't land in the middle of them engines.
Hold on there, strangers. And you is strange. Is you all cowboys or engines?
Well, I'm a hippo myself, and he's a monkey.
But we're leaning towards the cowboys.
Well, we're heading for Hollywood or bust. Going to get us our own wagon train show.
Wagon train show? You think it'll go?
It won't if we don't shake these engines.
No!
Will you get off my back? I mean front.
Gladly, sir. I'm also getting out of here.
Hold it. That arrow has a message on it.
Yowch!
It's from Chief Big Fella. He says, ugh, settle fight engine style. Send Paleface to fight Chief's son, Little Feather. Winner take all. Chief Big Fella. Paleface, huh?
Don't look so pale, Pete.
Congratulations. You is about to become a famous engine fighter like General Custer.
Oh, boy. What a way to become famous.
You got a deal, Chief Big Feather. I'm sending out our best pale-faced volunteer.
This is volunteering?
Oh, hippo, meet Chief Big Feather. You fight him Little Feather. First teepee on left.
If he's Big Feather, that Little Feather must be a tea guy. I'll just give him a little scare and let him quit. Okay, Little Feather. Give up now, and I'll put in a good word with a big chief in Washington. Now, that wasn't fair, Little Feather. You are Little Feather? I knew these Indian names would get me into trouble.
Going someplace, stranger?
I thought I'd go back and take on that Little Feather.
Me tie him wrists so we have a man-to-man fight, engine style. Me call him togetherness fight. When me fire, you fight him fight.
Careful with that thing, Chief. Yeah! Okay, okay. So you're strong. Put me down. Not on the head, on the ground. I must be doing what Custer did wrong.
Now is famous tomahawk fight. First, I throw tomahawk. Then you two run to tomahawk. Grab them and fight them out. Go.
Watch it, will you, Chief?
Me sorry.
Got the jump on him that time. Uh-oh. Crafty little kid, isn't he? I fooled him. Ouch! You know, I seem to be on the losing end. Ouch!
This what I call 'em engine wrestle. When me fire gun, you start 'em wrestle. Ready? That 'em funny, gun jam 'em.
I think I can handle the kid, but the old man is killing me. Listen, Chief, why don't you use blanks?
Me sorry.
Ouch! Okay, that's enough.
You lose. Now, Little Feather, give War Whoop before he give you engine haircut.
Yeah! I hate to be a big mouth, but you forced me into using my secret weapon, the Hippo Hurricane.
Okay, we lose. No can fight 'em big blowhard.
Good. Now the wagon train can go on to Hollywood.
Did you say 'em Hollywood?
Yeah, that's where the wagon train is headed. They're trying for a TV show.
Why didn't you say 'em so? We join up with wagon train. Come on, Little Feather.
Now's my chance to get back to the balloon.
They gonna need 'em plenty engines in cowboy TV series. We go Hollywood or bust. Make 'em heap big pile of wampum. Me love 'em tinsel and glitter. Whoopee! Yahoo!
Good luck, fellas.
Send us a postcard.
Okay, Pete. Let's give her a big blow.
And away we go!
Marshall, he just dug up the bank. He's headed for Deadwood.
You'll never get away with this, Slippery Sam.
Marshal Bob is riding Blaze, the fabulous new galloping horse from Mattel. See, his legs actually move just like a real horse. There's no other riding horse anywhere that gallops like Blaze. Now watch this. When you bounce on Blaze, he romps along like a frisky colt. He gallops when you rock back and forth on him, but he's so safe, you just can't tip over. Blaze is the safest, strongest horse made.
Okay, Slippery. This is the end of the line.
Almost got away, Marshal, if it weren't for that lightning-fast horse of yours. Where'd you get him?
You can get Mattel's Blaze wherever toys are sold.
And just wait till Dad sees how easy it is to set up. Just pop him out of the box, spread the stand, and tighten just one bolt. That's all there is to it. And see how safe and solidly built Blaze is. You can tell it's Mattel. It's swell.
Barbie, you're beautiful. You make me feel my Barbie doll is really real. Barbie's small and so petite. Her clothes and figure look so neat. Her dancing outfit rings a bell. At parties she will cast a spell. Purses, hats, and gloves galore, and all the gadgets gals adore.
Barbie dressed for swim and fun is only $3. Her lovely fashions range from $1 to $5. Look for Barbie wherever dolls are sold.
Someday I'm gonna be exactly like you. Till then, know just what I'll do. Barbie, beautiful Barbie. I'll make believe that
Well, it's Mattel. It's swell.
Up, scoop. Coast, stay clear. Fire one.
Two.
Fire two.
Two.
Fire three.
Two.
Cease firing. Steady now, Sneasley. I think we're in range. Oh, target sighted. There's the main gate. And look over there. It's Colonel Fuzzy and Sergeant Smedley tacking up a sign. And it says, USO show tonight.
Woohoo!
Put on your white tie and tail, Sneasley, cause it's showtime tonight.
But it's only for Army personnel, Breezley.
Well, then put on your field jacket and boondoggers.
Oh, boy, glad he's on our side.
Like I always say, if you can't beat him, join the Army. Oh, here comes the Colonel.
Wow, he's tall enough to be two guys. Two guys? And what two guys would try a trick like that? Breezley and Sneasley, what are you doing on my base?
Hang on, Sneasley, we have been spotted.
Guards, stop that man.
Got him, Colonel. I got front of him, sir.
Halt! I got the other part, sir.
And if I ever catch you on this base again, I'll launch you without a parachute.
Is this any way to run an airline? He only gave us one parachute.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Hang on.
Help!
The Colonel better brush up on his landings or we shall have to ground him. Well, sir, there's no telling where they'll build freeways nowadays. Hey, that's the camp show bus. Come on, Sneasley. We'll be late for the first act.
Better late than get clobbered by the Colonel.
Mighty nice of him to run a special bus to the base for us.
Welcome to Camp Frostbite, folks. Hot coffee and donuts in the officer's mess. Welcome, hot coffee and donuts in the officer's mess.
Well, that's mighty thoughty of you, Colonel.
Breezley Bruin, you polar pest!
Tisk, tisk, most unsociable person I've ever seen. I'll outbox them.
Where'd he go?
It's almost curtain time. I gotta put these props on stage. Marvel the Magician opens a show.
Presenting the great Marvel!
What the... You were expecting, perhaps, Peter Potamus?
Breezley Bruin, get off that stage! Pardon me!
Uh-oh, I'd better do my disappearing act. And away we go! Did you ever have the feeling that someone was following you?
He can't get away now!
I hate to bust up the trio, but three's a crowd.
One's one too many where you're concerned.
Sorry, Colonel. I didn't mean to upstage you, but I'm just a ham at heart. Use my exit. Oh, no!
Yahoo!
Sorry, pal, but I do a single.
And for his encore, I saw him in half.
Look good, Colonel, and we might get a job with the rocket. Whoa, what a case of professional jealousy.
Come back here, you showstopper.
Tell me, young man, why does a chicken cross the road?
To get away from the big bad colonel, that's why.
And I'm getting bigger and badder by the minute.
All this act needs is a good finish.
Greatest comedy act I've ever seen. You two, sign up with my USO unit and you'll be the biggest act in the camp show circuit.
Biggest act, eh? You mean showbiz, bright lights, glamour?
How about that, Colonel? We've been discovered.
Grizzly, old boy, we'll knock him dead.
Yep, Broadway, here we come.
I can see our name in lights. Fuzzy and Grizzly.
Fuzzy and Grizzly? What's wrong with Grizzly and Fuzzy?
I outrank you, Grizzly, so it's Fuzzy and Grizzly.
But I got the talent, so it's Grizzly and Fuzzy.
Fuzzy and Grizzly.
Grizzly and Fuzzy.
Guess I'm tight, Sneasley.
Grizzly and Fuzzy.
Fuzzy.
Grizzly.
Fuzzy.
What's the greatest jet prop airliner ever designed? Remco's Flying Fox. With real motor-driven jet prop engines, the giant cockpit with dual controls has room in it for two kids to control every action of the plane. In the air above the cockpit roars the mighty Flying Fox airliner. The engines are revved up separately from low to high speed. Hear that powerful jet sound get louder and louder as you rev her up? While flying, you retract the landing gear. You yourself make the plane climb, bank, dive, and turn in flight. While cockpit instruments keep you on course. For night flying, switch on the red and green wing lights and blink them. Kids, fly Remco's Flying Fox Jet Prop Airliner for the greatest thrill of your lifetime. Only $14.98. Remember, every boy wants a Remco toy, and so do girls.
Gaylord, the pup is full of tricks. Watch. Back up, Gaylord. Attaboy. Now climb, Gaylord. Up. Up. Now fetch your bowl. Got it. Good boy, Gaylord.
Gaylord, you look kind of crazy. Look kind of lazy. See what he'll do. Gaylord, when you pull his leash, he'll walkety-walkety-walk.
Gaylord comes with a bone of his own. He's a wonderful toy. He's ideal.
Gaylord, when you pull his leash, he'll walkety-walkety-walk with you.
The Peter Potamus Show has been presented by Ideal Toys. They're wonderful toys. They're ideal.
He's so debonair, flying through the air with a flair that is real. He's been everywhere, has that certain air and that certain appeal. Peter Potamus has a charm he could never conceal. We'll say so long, Peter Potamus, our ideal.
G.I. Joe, G.I. Joe, fighting man from head to toe, on the land, on the sea, in the air.
G.I. Joe attack! Boom, boom!
G.I. Joe takes the hill! Bam, bam!
Terrific battle!
Terrific equipment to have a battle with. When you get G.I. Joe and the authentic G.I. Joe equipment, you'll have the greatest realism, the greatest fun you ever had in playing soldier. Box after box of authentic uniforms and equipment so you can change your G.I. Joe soldier into a camouflage Marine ready for battle, a Navy frogman with complete scuba suit and inflatable life raft, an Air Force pilot with high-altitude helmet and air vest. Get G.I. Joe and get G.I. Joe equipment so you can set up exciting battle action whenever you want. Remember, only G.I. Joe is G.I. Joe.
Creepy crawlers, creepy crawlers, creepy crawlers.
Now, you can make all kinds of lovely things like these with Mattel's wonderful Thing Maker. It makes creepy crawlers, spiders, lizards, snakes, dragonflies. Make them yourself with this nice plastic goop. Choose a mold, pour in the goop, heat it, and presto changeo, you've got bugs. Squiggly, squirty bugs. It feels so soft and natural. You get four different colors of goop and special paints. Make charming lizard pins or spider rings. You can collect them or spread them around. After all, they are fun for the entire family. Get Mattel's new Thing Maker with creepy crawlers. You can tell it's Mattel. It's swell.
Ladies and gentlemen, before your very eyes, the Quaker Oats Company will now introduce two new cereals.
I'm Crisp, the crisp new cereal from outer space. The biggest selling cereal from Saturn to Alpha Centauri. Crisp is sugary sweet and vitamin charged to give you crazy energy. What's new with you?
I am Quake, the power cereal from inner space. Here at the Earth's core, I make Quake with deep down sweetness and vitamins to give you the power of an earthquake. Get Quake.
Crisp is better.
Fellas, why not leave it to the kids out there? Take sides with either Quake or Crisp.
Or Quake.
Or Crisp.
Two new cereals from Quaker. Sort of a breakfast feud.
The elusive smuggler, Captain Calamity, had always managed to slip through our fingers. So when we received a tip that he had been seen somewhere near the waterfront, Sergeant Judo and I rushed immediately to the scene. Well, here we are, Sergeant Judo. Now we'll get to the bottom of all this, eh? Stop here.
Oh, boy. This is one of those bad days. I should have stayed in the wrong side of bed.
Hey, Captain Calamity, you know what?
What is it, Crab Louie?
I think I see cops.
Cops? I hate cops. You know how I hate them. You know how they irritate me. And you know what happens when I get irritated. See? I break out in pearls.
Clam down, clam down. After all, that is what we are smuggling, no?
Listen, Crab Louie, they may be pearls to you, but they're ulcers to me.
We soon learned about the smuggler's ship, eh? She was anchored just offshore. Pull harder on those oars back there, Judo. That ship looked like it's about 10 miles out, and I want to reach her before dark. Faster. See? Faster. See? Ah, yes, I'm beginning to see her more clearly. You stupid fool, are you going to sit there? We're sinking.
I go get a new boat, and you wait right here, eh?
Next time, I sit in the back end. This is close enough, Judo.
See?
Don't say see, say we.
See, I mean we.
Ahoy there! This is the police.
What you want, copper?
I am coming aboard to search you. Drop a line.
Very well, here she comes.
One more rowboat's coming up, or going down. I don't know which end is open anymore, what to do about it.
Hold it steady, Judo, please. Eh?
See?
Say we, not see.
Okay, okay, boss, but you know, I think I'm getting a little wee-sick.
That's see, not we.
I got enough sea already.
All right, all of you in there, don't move. This is the police.
That was just a warning, copper.
I think the inspector must be, you know, one of those guys, an underwater cover agent, one of those... I don't know.
This way, if I sink, you sink.
See?
There they come again! I knew they wouldn't give up! I knew it! I knew it!
Don't worry, mon capitaine. This time I fix those coppers real good, you bet.
Well, it's back to the dry dock, or the dry gooses. I don't know. I'm going to call Mom.
Now you understand, Judo. This operation calls for absolute silence.
See?
Shut up, you fool! Not another word out of you!
Hey, Inspector. It's okay if I talk now?
It became obvious to me that this case did not present much of a challenge. So, before I became bored with the whole affair, I decided to close in on the culprits.
Ooh, that's a cold luger.
Put up your clammy hands. You're under arrest.
Don't shoot. I'll tell you anything you want to know. I'll squeal. I'll blab. I'll spill the works. I'll talk. Just try me. Ask me anything. I'll talk. I'll talk.
This is a clam?
Drop it, copper. Don't try to shoot it out. You got no place to duck for cover.
That is where you are sadly mistaken, monsieur. That will be sufficient. Now drop those weapons.
You heard him! Drop him! Drop him!
Judo, dear boy, attend to the formalities of the arrest, please.
See, Inspector. Okay, you hombres, your goose is cooked. So don't fool around, because, oh boy, if you do.
Are you ready down there, Judo?
See.
I want you to tow this ship into port as evidence.
See, Inspector, are you coming down now?
No, no, my dear boy, I'm going to ride on this one. Those little boats aren't safe, eh?
Okay, amigos, start to row pronto. Holy frijoli, the poor inspector, he's sinking down in the sea.
Don't say sea, say we.
What's wackier than a gorilla in a box?
New banana walkies!
Whee! A Trix Rabbit whistle. Inside every specially marked box of Trix. Trix whistles are arresting. Each whistle plays three notes. And a chord. Start a Trix Rabbit Whistle Club. Wear it on your keychain instead of a rabbit's foot. To get yours, look for the specially marked Trix package. Trix, the delicious corn cereal with the tangy taste of natural fruit. Fruit colors, too. Raspberry red, lemon yellow, orange, orange. And there you'll find your free Trix Rabbit whistle. But remember, Trix Rabbit whistles, like Trix, are for kids.
Baldy taught me magic. Put Frosty-O's in.
And Baldy comes out. Frosty-O's are for breakfast.
Frosty-rific snacking, too.
Shaped like sugar-frosted donuts. Frosty-O's.
It's Percy!
She has a new sister, Cricket.
Cricket? Ooh, her hair grows too.
Percy! Cricket, what a pair! Set and style their beautiful hair. They have hair that grows, legs that pose, and new low-price budget clothes.
You can create lovely young hairdos for Cricket with Tressie's Hair Glamour Pack.
It's fun to play with Tressie and Cricket.
Dress up sisters with dress-up hair.
Look at all these outfits.
Now you can have a different outfit to go with each hairdo for Tressie and Cricket. Here's Cricket all dolled up, and her outfit costs less than a dollar.
Tressie, Cricket, what a pair! Set and style their beautiful hair. They love to pose in their lovely clothes, designed to match their hair that grows.
Get budget clothes for Tressie and Cricket. What a pair! By American Character.
The news of the Mad Boomer's prison break put the commissioner in a state of extreme agitation.
Inspector, we must apprehend this madman. As you know, he swore to get the official that sent him to prison. And that official is me.
But don't worry, I will protect you.
Hey, this gift package here, this came for the commissioner. Maybe that's his birthday or something, eh?
Don't touch it. It could be a bomb. Judo.
See?
Take this package down to the lab and subject it to the usual tests, please.
See?
And don't say see, say we.
See? I mean we. I mean, what do I mean? It didn't explode, I see. I mean we.
So you see it was absolutely harmless, huh? Here, listen to the cuckoo. Oh, dear Commissioner, I...
Shut up! I've listened to enough cuckoos for one day.
But, Commissioner, the safest place for you is where the Mad Boomer is not, which is right here, which is where he is now, right?
Bah! A fine state of affairs! The police are locked up while the crooks roam around free!
Just a moment. Do you have a license to peddle these balloons? Well, it's a good thing you have.
I don't believe it. I believe it.
To further ensure the commissioner's safety, I decided that we should leave immediately for his country estate. Wait. I had better check to see if the car has been wired with a boom. Everything is perfect, sir. You may get in. What nasty luck, a blowout. Well, we'll take the armor-plated compact instead.
Quick, pull over to the curb!
Was I speeding?
No, no, you fool! It's the Mad Bomber! He's running up that hill! After him!
Stop or I'll shoot! I warn you, I have been trained to kill.
Ha, 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 ha,
Taxi! Taxi!
We finally arrived at the commissioner's country house, where we enjoyed the simple pastoral life. I have made a thorough search, and you can be sure that there is not one boom on these premises.
Oh, that's splendid. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two.
Commissioner, can you hear me? If so, signify by moving your hand. The commissioner impressed it upon me to search more painstakingly, and I soon met with success. To render a boom harmless, first you must remain composed, and second, plunge the boom into water as quickly as possible.
I hate you.
We found the French Riviera most enjoyable.
Hurry up with my sunburn lotion.
Coming, sir. Aha. What is this? Could it be a fuse? I believe it is a fuse. Commissioner!
Yes?
Here's your sunburn lotion. I decided it would be safer to get out of France.
Well, there's no bombers up here, eh, Inspector?
But of course not. Relax and enjoy yourself.
Peace and quiet at last.
My unerring powers of deduction finally led to the capture of the elusive Mad Boomer, and I magnanimously allowed the credit to pass to my superior. The photographers are here now, sir.
Very good. Send them in. Take off your hat, you ill-mannered idiot!
And so with that, I mark the case officially closed. And that was the last of the Mad Boomer. Or was it?
Mountain Dew!
Oh, beautiful Sal was a stone-hearted gal, refusing to bill or to coo. But Clem was right smart, he appealed to her heart with that gal getting good old Mountain Dew.
Mountain Dew will tickle your innards, cause there's a bang in every bottle.
At the county turkey shoot, cause Luke weren't worth a hoot, he was hopeless till he finally took the cue.
Yahoo! Mountain Dew!
Now he shoots off the cuff, gets more than enough, after nipping at that good old Mountain Dew.
Sure as shooting, there's a bang in every bottle of our delicious soft drink, Mountain Dew. It'll tickle your innards.
Quaker presents Your Breakfast Cereal. Co-starring Quisp, the crazy energy cereal from outer space, and Quake, the earthquake cereal from the center of the earth. Last time, we left kindly old Dr. Green in a terrible fix.
Help! The roaring flames!
Our heroes dash to the rescue.
Buzz off, tiny tot. Fighting fires takes power. Like I get from Quake, the cereal with vitamins and deep down sweetness.
Wrong. Rescuing people from burning buildings takes speed. Like I get from sugary sweet Quake, the vitamin charge for Quake the energy. Help! The roaring flames!
Try Quake, Doctor.
In a Quake, you need Quake.
Which will kindly old Dr. Green choose to save him from the roaring flames? Which would you choose? Wisps or Quake? And don't miss our next episode, What's Cooking? Doc?
Meet the men from Super Service. Facing danger just for kicks. Half a dozen super strong men who are called the Super Six. Super Six! Super Six! Battle criminals and all their evil games. Super Six! Super Six!
evildoers to the
land, foul and slow.
Down the fear of darkness, giving crime an uppercut. Five great thunderbolts of power, and a bolt who is a nut. Super Six, Super Six, they give their own for Super Six.
Super Service Headquarters, the Supermen are lined up eagerly, awaiting the daily assignments. Day or night, Super Service, dispatcher speaking. A what wolf? Oh, a werewolf. Okay, we'll get right on it. Hey, you, Captain Whammo.
Me, sir? Yes, sir.
Get over to Pasadena. There's an old maid wrestling with a werewolf.
Oh, I shall rush to her aid at once, sir. Hither, yonder, and away!
Not her aid, you idiot! It was the werewolf who called! Oh, boy, what a way to run a super rental service.
Hey, Chief, got a job for me this morning? I'm really swinging.
Cool it on the bench, Superboy. You aren't ready for the big ones yet. You're just an apprentice.
Aw, gee, I never get a chance to show what I can do.
Hey, listen to this. $500,000 involved in Gottrock's kidnapping.
Gottrock's kidnapping? This is a job for Superboy! Zip, slam, zowie, and swoosh!
Spends $500,000 to build soundproof nursery just so his kid can take a nap. Meanwhile, Super Boeing is many miles away, flying through the sky.
Now, where would a kidnapper hide a kid? I'll use my powerful X-ray vision and scout around.
Super Boeing's keen eyes scan the buildings with his X-ray vision penetrating solid stone. He decides to look into one.
Ah, a guy stuffing a kid into a suitcase. That's the kidnapper, as sure as my name is Superboy. He's heading for the elevator. Well, he won't get far.
Superboy smashes through the roof of the elevator housing. He ascends, holding the elevator cable.
Lobby floor, watch your step.
The ventriloquist walks out into thin air. Superboy swoops down on the falling suitcase.
Gotcha, kid!
I am going to sue you! Oh, boy, am I going to sue you!
I'll bet old man Gottrox will pay a handsome reward to get Junior back. Those darn air pockets. There goes my reward.
Several hundred yards up the track, a freight train is speeding toward the suitcase.
Junior! Zip, slam, zowie, and swoop! Gee Whittaker, that was a close one!
Superboy resumes his mission of mercy.
I'll have you home in a jiffy, kid.
And as he dodges a projecting steeple, the suitcase slips off the guitar handle.
Oh, darn it, I've lost him again. Hey, come back with that suitcase. I know what you got in there, and I want it. Let me have it. That must be another gang of kidnappers. I'll fix them. No more tricks, you guys. Why that again? How'd you like that? Zip, slam, zowie, and swoop! Doggone it, that gang will stop at nothing. I
a good thing I always carry a large cork for emergencies like this. Dirty backstabbers! I'll fix you!
Look, fellas, don't blame the Air Force. You see, there was this nut, and he was...
The Got Rocks Estate, you're home at last.
Oh, I finally got that kid to sleep. Now I can read the Wall Street Journal in peace.
Grieve no more. Superboying is here.
Stay away from me. Look at that. You woke him up. Why, I even went to the expense of building him a $500,000 nursery.
You've been doped. That's not your son. This is your son. Returned safely to your bosom by me, Superboy. It's a dummy.
Well, it takes one to know one. Wilkins! The dogs!
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. This is a job for Superboy?
Uh-oh, it's Jean LaFoot, the barefoot pirate.
Now, Captain, you will tell me the secret.
Secret?
The secret of what makes Cap'n Crunch cereal so crunchy.
Oh, well, you see, Cap'n Crunch is made of two nourishing grains. Corn for crunch, oats for punch. Sweetened just right and...
But how does it stay crunchy even after you pour on the milk?
Oh, well, that's a secret.
I know it's a secret, and I must have it. Give it to me. Give it to me.
Very well. Sea Dog, give it to him. Hello, Quaker Oats Company? Say, how does my cereal keep its crunch? Uh-huh. Yeah, I thought so.
Well?
Just as I thought. It's a secret. Let's go, Sea Dog. I hate to see a grown pirate cry.
Captain Crunch from Quaker Oats.
Well, you better defend yourself, Granite Man, because I'm going to use every trick in the book.
To give your all is the rule of good sportsmanship, Superboying.
Darn right. I'm going to lead with a left hook, then let you have an uppercut, then finish you off with the old one, two.
Okay. Out into the center of the ring and shake hands.
No hard feelings.
It's a pleasure. Shake. Dear, forgive me, Superboying.
I concede defeat.
The sleepy little Klondike town of Grimy Gulch is suddenly aroused by the arrival of Dirty Pierre, the foulest, filthiest, most unsanitary man in the Yukon.
Yahoo! Eureka! I found mud! I found mud! I am filthy rich! Give me a glass of sour milk.
Sour milk? I thought you was tough.
Put that in a dirty glass, you pipsqueak.
Meanwhile, at Mounted Police Headquarters in Fort Debris, the Major is instructing his troops.
Troops, something has got to be done about this dirty town. It's a disgrace. Imagine being declared a disaster area 17 times in 1 week.
Confusion, say? Grimy Gulch like broken fortune cookie. Real crummy.
Exactly. That's why I'm going to have you boys clean it up. And you can start in by cleaning up Dirty Pierre.
fill her up again and put a scoop of dirt in it.
We're gonna clean up this town, starting with you, Dirty Pierre.
You're not going to clean up nothing. Now get out of here.
Mr. Pierre doesn't want to be cleaned up, so let's quit.
What? Are we men or are we Mounties? Come on!
Give me another, and put in more dirt this time. Oh no, they are cleaning me. I will get double pneumonia in both lungs. Get away! I got to get myself dirty fast! I cannot stand to be clean.
You know, I don't think Mr. Pierre likes us very much.
So what?
So I don't think we should antagonize him. He has an explosive temper, you know.
Confusion, say. Best way to disarm explosive is from long distance.
Long distance call for Dirty Pierre.
Long distance, eh? It must be Mama. Call to tell me why I no get my mud pie this month. Hello, Mama. Where is my mud pie? Nobody can bake mud pies like Mama. Oh no, not again! And my mud pie, she is wash off! This is too much! Just wait until I catch those Mazzo Mounties. I make them like the potato! Hey, you crazy Indian, you! What for you are jump up and down, eh?
Do dance. Make 'em rain.
Make the rain, you stupid, superstitious aborigines. Rain? Okay, fui. It always make my skin break out.
Confusion say, man go on tour, get taken for a ride.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. The free tour of Grimy Gulch leaves in 5 minutes. Come one, come all. See the dumps, tour the slums, all free.
Oh boy, me first, me first. Oh, a bathtub. They fool me again.
There's only one way left to deal with Dirty Pierre. One of us will have to shoot him. Think of a number between 1 and 10.
6.
Right. You get to shoot Dirty Pierre. Come on.
But I don't fit. I mean, I never... I didn't...
Okay, White. Go ahead. Shoot him.
So, you're going to shoot Dirty Pierre, eh? That is so funny! Of all the dirty trick, a water gun! This is the rottenest trick of all! Now I cannot get dirty no more.
And in recognition of your fine work in cleaning up Grimy Gulch, it gives me great pleasure to present you with the Silver Squeegee.
Well, if you cannot lick them, join them. Ha 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 ha
Hey, you guys, got a second? My name is Rolf, and I'm a Muppet, see? You know the Muppets, they're that nutty bunch of puppets that keep turning up on TV these days. Anyhow, Ideal is making a plush toy of me, and it looks like this.
What?
Oh, well, I was Snurf. He's another Muppet. And Ideal makes a Snurf Muppet, too. But the little Rolf Muppet looks like this.
I am a Kermit. I'm made by Ideal. I think you'll agree I have real appeal.
Yeah. Well, that was Ideal's Kermit Muppet, but I'm trying to show you the Rolf. Now, cut that out. Now, here's the Rolf Muppet. Go ahead, kid. Explain yourself.
I am the little Rolf. You can work me like a puppet or play with me like a doll.
Thank you, Junior. You can go now.
Oh, buy us, we beg. For if you don't buy us, we'll bite you in the leg.
Now, hold on. What kind of an attitude is that?
So buy us
at once
a bundle of charms.
And if you don't buy us, we'll break both your arms.
Okay, that's enough. Friends, buy the Ideal Muppets. The kids will be screaming for them.
How about shining up my boots, my little friend?
Sure thing, elevator man. But it's gonna cost you 50 cents this time.
What? Why, that's robbery. You used to charge me only a dime.
Yeah, but the price of shoe polish has gone up.
Okay. Here's 50 cents. But you gotta promise to do a good job.
You can depend on it. I'll go get my shoe shine kit. Be back in a jiffy. Gee gosh, Wilkins! Well, what are you, a wise guy or something?
A deal's a deal. Shine him up.
This is the city, but all is not peaceful in this city. Deep within this innocent-looking building is the laboratory of Dr. Szabo Tour. What evil concoction is Dr. Szabo conjuring up now? Let's listen.
Olaf, this will be my greatest invention. Now watch.
It's gone.
Yes, gone. Disappeared before your very eyes. I have devised an instant cement disintegrator. It is the greatest invention of my career.
That's what you said about this instant dandruff remover. And it turned out to be a flop.
Flop? Why, there is nothing like it for making dandruff disappear.
Sure, but it also makes everything else disappear. Everything.
All right, so it has a couple of bugs in it. But this, Olaf, my instant cement disintegrator is perfect.
What are we doing here, Doctor? Are we going to make a deposit?
No, Olaf. We are going to make a withdrawal. Watch. Quick, Olaf. Attach this to the safe. All right, Harvey. Heave ho, and away we go. Good work, boys. Now let's get out of here fast.
Later at Super Service Central.
You say the bank was robbed? What did they take? The whole building? But they can't get away with that. This is a job for Granite Man. Hey, Percy, come here.
Me?
Percy, get over to the park. Tell Granite Man the bank at 7th and Grand is missing.
Oh, you mean it's been robbed?
I mean it's missing. Robbed and missing.
Oh, boy, I'd better hurry. Granite Man, oh, rock of power, awaken face of this dangerous hour.
Hello, Percy. What's the trouble?
Someone robbed the bank, and the cops are baffled.
Okay, let's be on our way. You'd better scout around and see if you detect anything of a suspicious nature.
A check.
Do you see anything?
I see a truck with a safe on it.
Come on!
Hey, Doc, there's a guy and a bird on a motorcycle, and they're coming up fast.
Let them come. I have a little surprise for them. My instant cement disintegrator. There. That should do the trick.
Hit the brakes. Half the bridge is gone.
Well, Percival, it appears that from now on we go by foot.
You go by foot, Granite Man. It's such a nice day, I think I'll fly. So that's their hideout. Boy, I'd better get Granite Man over here right away.
All right, Olaf. Go to work on it.
Your little game is up, Dr. Saboteur.
It's Granite Man. Quick, Olaf. Give him a hot foot all over.
Hey, Doc, he acts like he's enjoying it. The fire's got no effect on him.
Well, let's see how this quick-drying cement sets with him.
I can't move.
Okay, Olaf. Take him outside and put him in the rock crusher.
So long, Granite Man. You make somebody a nice rock garden.
I'll save you, Granite Man. Don't worry. I'll be right back.
One for you, two for me. Two more for me. And one for you. Two for me, plus one more for me.
Gee, I sure hope this works.
It's a good thing I made of granite instead of cement. And now come. We must stop that fiendish doctor.
Do you know how my mother has to scrub floors? Well, I'm getting her a new mop and pail.
And this is only the beginning.
You're wrong, Doctor. This is the end.
Don't you ever knock.
It's prison for you two. You'll get 99 years, maybe even life.
Oh, yes? You got to catch us first. No, no, not that. Not my dandruff remover.
Here come the police. What do we tell them?
We'll tell them that Dr. Saboteur and Olaf just disappeared.
This program is brought to you by Kellogg's, the greatest name in cereals. Kellogg's.
If you should go around the world, you could always hear this familiar sound. Snap, crackle, pop. Snap, crackle, pop.
Snap, crackle, pop makes the world go round. Kellogg's Rice Krispies.
In Finland, these morsels of toasted rice are called Riisi Muroha. They say Fox Ricks Rocks. Switzerland called them Riisi Nusperli Krustiris. Beep, bap, boop. Same good Kellogg's Rice Krispies. In Mexico, arroz tostadito, bim bum bam, the Mexicano sound. Quebec, where everything talk in French, it's creak, crack, croc, make Quebec go round.
Kellogg's Good Fried Krispies.
Bim bum bam, box licks sucks, beep bap boop. Whatever the sound, it's nice to know, wherever you go, it's
snap, crack, pop, makes the world go round. Kellogg's best to you.
Meet the men.
and super service. Facing danger just for kicks. Half a dozen super strong men who are called the Super Six. Super Six! Super Six! Battle criminals and all their evil games. Super Six! Super Six! Evil doers dread the mention of their names. Putting down the fear of darkness, giving crime an uppercut. Five great thunderbolts of power, and a bolt who is a nut. Super Six! Super Six! They give their all for Super Six!
Yes, Mr. LaFoot, this is the crunchiest mixture ever made.
Good. Hello, Captain Crunch.
Ow!
I, Jean LaFoot, challenge you to a crunching contest.
But LaFoot, nothing's crunchier than Cap'n Crunch cereal. It's sweet and delicious, made of corn and oats with two kinds of sugar. And it's made crunchy to stay crunchy even after you pour on the milk. What can possibly match it?
My own cereal, Footsies.
Gentlemen, take three paces, turn, and crunch. One, two, three, turn. The winner is Cap'n Crunch cereal.
Yay! And this stuff tastes awful.
It is crunchy, though.
What's it made of?
Eggshells, celery sticks, and just a pinch of blackboard chalk.
Sorry, LaFoot.
What I can't stand is this crunchier-than-thou attitude.
Get Cap'n Crunch cereal from Quaker.
Hi, Riverdale High is throwing a costume dance tomorrow night with a prize for the best costume. I hear Jughead considered going as a hamburger, but the onions kept making his eyes water.
Mary, we're having an earthquake!
It's all right, Fred. It's just Archie and his school friends. They're trying to come up with costume ideas for the school dance.
I hope they come up with something before the ceiling comes down.
Will the crowd sees my costume. I'm sure to win first prize.
I'll get it, dear.
Hello, Mr. Andrews.
Hello, Reggie. You know, Mary, that's the first time I've seen that boy without his hair pasted down with greasy kid stuff.
It's a swell costume, Reggie, but...
Well?
We were just considering going as a group. Yeah, and share first prize if we win.
Are you with us, Reg?
Are you kidding? Most certainly not. With this costume, I'm sure to win, and I'm not sharing first prize with anyone. Good night, Mr. Andrews.
Good night, Reggie. He's pasted his hair down again.
Well, that narrows our group down to four.
With Reggie so sure he'll win, it hardly seems worth trying to come up with a costume.
I got it. Let's go as the four losers.
Very funny.
What you got there, hot dog? Hey, by golly, you've done it.
What is it, Archie?
Hey, men from Mars.
Groovy. Why not?
We can even fix my car up as a flying saucer.
Cool. That'll give old Red some competition.
That's what they think.
Are you still hanging around, Reggie?
Well, that just about does it, Arch.
It's just too
real boss, Arch.
Thanks, girls.
If that's not way out, I don't know what is.
Did you girls finish the costumes?
That all done, Archie.
Keen.
We didn't forget you, hot dog. Here.
How about that? I always wondered what the world looked like to a goldfish.
When we get the rest of our outfits on, we'll be all set to go.
Archie and Jug did do a convincing job on that flying saucer, and those are good costumes. Convincing flying saucer. Say, that could be the answer to my winning the costume prize.
Hop in, girls.
Standing by for blast off.
All aboard for the moon, Jupiter, Mars, and Riverdale High.
Hello, Riverdale Police. I just saw a Martian flying saucer headed down Pear Street toward Peach. You better hurry. It looks like an invasion force. And now to take my time getting to the dance and pick up first prize.
What did Archie and his wrecking crew finally decide on for costumes, dear?
Oh, I don't know, Fred. I was so busy with the dishes when they left, I didn't notice.
Here's a news bulletin. A Martian flying saucer invasion of Riverdale has just been reported.
Oh, Fred, the children, the school dance.
Oh, my goodness, those poor Martians.
This is car 4 moving east on Peach, approaching Pear. No sign of UFO. Proceeding north to Apple. Over.
Oh, ow! Somebody give me a hand!
What's wrong, Juggy?
I was just snacking on a banana and my hand got stuck. Phew! Thanks, Betty.
A siren! I'd better pull over.
Stop at that service station, Arch. I want to wash my hands.
Yeah, I can use some air in my tires, too.
Hurry, boys. We don't want to be late.
Now, this is car 4 proceeding north on Apple. Just spotted UFO moving east on a banana.
Watch it, Charlie!
This car 4, what happened?
We just went into a slippery spin.
On banana? That figures.
No fooling. They must have used some kind of spin ray on us. Who knows what kind of weapons they have? Come on, Charlie, let's take cover.
Can't you hurry with those tires, Archie?
I'm hurrying, Ronnie.
Hey, Art, the station attendant took one look at me and said something about taking me to his leader. And then he ran off.
Oh, boy, a flat!
Let's take cover further back, Charlie. They're shooting.
Let's walk, Betty.
Yeah, we'll never get to the dance at this rate.
I think I'll take a shortcut across the park to Apple.
Let's get out of here.
We'll meet you boys at the dance. Don't take too long.
We'll be right there.
Car 4 to headquarters. They're too much for us. Send help. Quick, the Martians have freed the animals. Apes are running loose in the park. No wonder. They're animals themselves.
I wonder if those policemen were looking for Archie and his Martians. Sounds like the whole police force is out.
The saucer's headed toward Riverdale High.
Riverdale police are swarming toward Apple and Banana Streets like flies.
That's what we get for naming streets after fruit trees.
Fred, please. This is frightening.
I've just been handed a bulletin. The Martians have been captured just outside Riverdale High School. A mobile unit is just approaching the scene.
There now, dear. Shortly, you'll see that this whole thing has been a silly hoax.
Look, Fred, there's one of the Martians. They're taking off his helmet.
Egads, it's not a hoax. Look at that hideous face.
Fred, that's Jughead Jones. And there's Archie.
And now, before I award the prize for the best costume,
I think I should mention that tonight shall more than likely go down in history of Riverdale as the night Riverdale proved that the Martians had better not land here.
I heard that the news spread clear across the country.
Really?
The press wants more pictures of us in our flying saucer, Hutch.
And now, because of such convincing costumes, the award goes to Veronica, Betty, Archie, Jughead, and Hot Dog.
On behalf of the rest, thank you, Mr. Weatherby. And I'd like to congratulate our Riverdale Police Department for an excellent job and the manner in which they handled the situation. Oh, yes, and to Reggie Mantle, whom the police say admitted he was the one who tipped them off.
Somebody let me out of here. I'm not an ape. There are no Martians. Now let me out or I'll be late for winning the best costume award.
Look, kids, it's just about time for the Archie Dance of the Week. In just a few moments, the gang and I will show you another brand new groovy dance step that you can all watch and learn. So, don't go away. And now, a brand new dance to watch and learn. The stick shift.
Jump one straight ahead, and now you're in first. Jump twice, straight back. And now you're in second, jump straight to the right. And now you're in third, then twice, straight back. And now you're in fourth, now jump to the middle. That's neutral. And that's the stick shift.
Crackos, Crackos, wake up for Crackos.
Who are you?
I'm Cracko, with my new Waker Upper cereal, Post-Corn Crackos. Have you heard what happens when you crack into Crackos?
Mm-mm.
Don't talk when you're cracking.
Fire! Who's making that racket?
A banana!
Fire.
It crackles when you crunch.
Corn Crackos, new from Post. Crackling little twists of golden corn cereal, sugary sweet and crisp enough to drive you wild.
Crackos, Crackos, wake up for Crackos.
Have you heard what happens when you crack into Crackos?
Are you kidding?
I'm Cracko. Say, how'd you do?
What's all that noise?
You, Marshall!
We're doing gangs in town.
Bustlers, I'll tell you.
I heard it. It crackles when you crunch.
You hear it too, mate. Get new Post-Corn Crackos.
Battleship! 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 Milton Bradley's great game of strategy. It's loaded with action and suspense. Play it anytime, anywhere.
B4. Hit. J1. Huh! You missed. J10. Earl, you smoke like Battleship!
Battleship! A game of strategy from Milton Bradley.
Now let's dance it to a brand new song.
Well, it's a candy apple hunker with a cocoa brown vinyl top.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Power disc breaks, what it takes to make it stop.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I put my friends in the back seat, me in the front seat, my baby at my side, and we just ride, ride, ride. Son of a gun.
Ride, 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 ride.
Got a 411 rear and it's hot by a half a ton.
Ride, 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 ride.
It's got a human reaction and positive traction. Can't make it slide. And we just ride, ride, ride.
Ride, 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 ride,
seats, I'm told, are leather, and the steering wheel is made of wood.
Ride, 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 ride.
They'd like to want to fly, and you know sometimes I think it could.
Ride, 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 ride.
I got a new set of drag wheels, you know they're mag wheels, 11 inches wide, and we just ride, 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 ride.
Miss Grundy sure hands out some dillies of assignments. I'm supposed to use defeat, defense, and detail in a sentence. Defeat, defense, detail. That's it. That's it. Defeat of the cat went over defense before detail.
Hi, gang. Riverdale science class is going on a field trip to the mountains. Why don't you join us?
We shall be arriving at our mountain destination in a few moments, class. And may I once again remind you that we all stay close together as we embark on an adventure amongst nature's wonderland in the wilds. Correct, Mr. Weatherby?
Correct, Miss Grundy.
Big deal.
The first prize of an A for the day will be awarded to the finder of the most unusual phenomenon of nature in nature's very own backyard, where nature's little creatures are...
Boy, being a stowaway on a school bus ain't easy. Isn't easy.
Together!
Miss Grundy, isn't this going a bit too far?
At last, the great outdoors!
Well, well, a stowaway, eh?
Oh, caught in the act!
Don't worry, hot dog, I'll keep your little secret. And since you caught me lagging behind, I'll let you in on my secret. I'm gonna create some really unusual phenomenons of nature.
Something tells me I should have stayed in the bus.
When I finish with this gay little outing, everyone will think they've made the best find of the day.
Genuine teensy flies. Oh, boy. Hey, Arch, wait up.
Oh, what is it, Jug? Hey, what's in a box?
I caught some genuine, honest-to-goodness teensy flies.
Really?
Wait till Miss Grundy sees this.
Oh, Jughead, you silly boy. That's not teensy flies. They're just common, ordinary gnats.
Gnats? They're teensy flies.
Gnats.
Teensy flies.
Gnats.
Teensy flies.
Gnats.
Okay, okay, have it your way. Teensy flies to me, gnats to you.
You, Jughead, you!
Take it easy!
Go get him, Veronica!
Woo-hoo. Miss Grundy! Now, where did she go to? Oh, a frog must have accidentally jumped into that old paper bag. Now there's an unusual phenomenon. Now hold still, bag. Now, where did you go? Beggy, beggy, beggy.
Don't look now, but Reggie has hooked a live one.
Hey, beggy. Oh, there you are.
Oh, Miss Grundy, would you hold this for me?
Why, certainly, Reginald.
By the way, Mr. Weatherby's looking for you.
He is.
Aha! There's the bag.
Oh, really?
Please, Miss Grundy, that's not what I meant.
Listen, Archie, I hear a stream nearby.
Yeah, maybe we can find some fish eggs.
Watch this, hot dog.
Look, Betty, there's some fish eggs down there.
I can't see them. Where?
Well, look closer, down there.
Oh!
Gee, Betty, you didn't have to look that close.
You did that on purpose, Archie Andrews.
There, I told you. It must have been a goat.
Well, all right, this time.
Well, I'm certainly glad we straightened out our little misunderstanding, Miss Grundy.
You have my sincerest apologies, Mr. Weatherby.
I'm going to find an anthill and get some photos.
Now, let's see. Where was I? Oh, yes. I was looking at this teeny bug. It's looking back.
It's just me, Miss Grundy.
Oh, Reginald.
I just thought I should warn you, there's a goat in these parts, and it's running around butting people into streams and such.
You don't say. Well, I'll be on the alert for it, Reginald. Thank you.
Forget it. Oh, hi, Mr. Weatherby. You looking for something?
Yes, Reggie. Ants.
Gee, I saw a bunch up in that bush back there a bit.
Thanks, Reggie. You're a great help.
That must definitely be a bugus biomitis. No, you don't. Take that, you old goat.
Really, Miss Grundy? Can't you forgive and forget?
Come on, hot dog, now for some real fun.
Oh, why did I have to stow away on that bus and become a partner to crime? Surely justice will prevail in the end.
In the least, Jughead Jones. I still think you pushed me into that stream, Archie Andrews.
Wait a minute, gang. What's going on around here? What was supposed to be a friendly and scientific trip has turned into a regular brawl.
Yeah, half the kids are sore at each other, and Mr. Weatherby isn't speaking to Miss Grundy.
Hey, hot dog, you can't back out now.
My life of crime is over. I'm giving myself up.
Hot dog!
He must have stowed away on the bus.
Say, hot dog, what do you know about all those strange happenings?
Of course!
Reggie! Come on, gang, let's follow.
Forget the apologies, Miss Grundy. What's one more lump? Now I have a match set.
Oh, a bear!
Hang on, Miss Grundy. I'll save you.
Hush up, hot dog. I knew you'd come back.
So you see, Mr. Weatherby, we have reason to believe someone is behind all those strange happenings.
Reggie Mantle?
Of course.
Look, a bear!
I'll take care of this. How dare you disrupt our little field trip, Reginald Mantle? Shame, shame, shame on you!
Wait, Miss Grundy, that's not me. It's a real bear.
Good heavens! Run for your lives, class!
Wait, gang, look! The bear is placing the blame where it really belongs. How about this? Everything sure turned out for the best.
It certainly did, Archie. The A for the day goes to Mr. B for bear.
Imagine that. A guided tour of the forest by Mr. Bear himself.
You might say this is a typical happy ending. That is, for some of us.
Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle.
Yeah, monkey's uncle.
New stunt race day
with a monkey business name.
Spread the stunts out every place. Make it tough to win the race. Running wild, monkey's uncle. Why the timer running take? The stunt that says be a snake. It's great, monkey's uncle. Time is going tick, tick, tick. Do a rooster who is sick. Cock-a-doodle, choo. Run wild, monkey's uncle. Hurry, hurry, do those tricks. For the monkey out of ticks. Run wild, monkey's uncle. Time, now's your turn to show your speed. Do more stunts and take the lead. Run wild, monkey's uncle. Catch a fish and give a toot. Be an owl who cries,
woo-hoo.
It's fun, monkey's uncle.
Time,
wiggle, waddle, quick, quick, quick. To the builder,
tower trick. 12 stunts, just 3 tides. Case of ties in monkey's eyes. And you're a monkey's uncle. It's wild! Complete with stunt mats, cards, horns, clickers, tricks, spinner, and monkey timer. From Transigram, where the fun comes from.
Everything's Archie. Archie's here. Daddy's here. Veronica too. Reggie's here. Hey Jughead, where are you? We wanna dance and we wanna sing. Have some fun and we're adventuring. All our friends are here, but it ain't complete. We ain't the Archies without the Jughead beat. Whoa, Archie's here. Daddy's here. Veronica too. Reggie's here. And here comes Jughead and Hot Dog too. So everything's Archie.
Are you all right?
Yes, son. But whoever it was packs quite a punch.
Then you didn't see his face?
No, it was too dark. But he must be the one who's behind those accidents.
Accidents? What accidents?
Remember the night before last when I went up on deck for some fresh air? Well, I was only out there a few minutes when suddenly... Then last night, I was below checking out gear when something struck me from behind. When I regained consciousness, I noticed a large block and tackle swinging from the overhead. I assumed it was that that hit me. But after what happened tonight, I realized they were no accidents.
But why would anyone want to harm you, Dad?
Because whoever it is knows the real reason I brought you on this voyage. And it's time that you knew, too.
I thought we were searching for a lost island.
Now, that's only part of it. Somewhere on that island, there's a fortune in buried treasure. And this map shows exactly where it is.
Buried treasure? Then whoever was behind those attacks was really after the map.
That's right. So from now on, we must be on our guard at all times. For I'm afraid he'll stop at nothing to get this map.
Aye, you're so right, Mr. Gulliver.
Is blocking the door.
No, we're not. We can squeeze through the porthole. All right, Tag. You're next. Someone's at the door, Tag. I better hide the map in your collar for safekeeping. There. Now hurry, boy. Out the porthole!
You ain't going nowhere, Mr. Gulliver.
So it was you, Captain Leech.
Aye. And now I'll take that map.
How long we've been drifting. Seems like days. This heat. Gotta reach land soon. An island! Hang on, Tank! We made it, Tank.
Look, Plum, on the beach.
Monsters.
Quiet. Do you want to wake them? Quick, then, call the king.
You're right. We've been invaded by giants.
What are we going to do, Your Majesty?
What are we going to do? We must capture them. Yes, yes, that's it. Tie them up. Should hold those giants?
Yes, Your Majesty. They will never break free.
Hey,
Who are you?
The giants! They're waking up!
What's going on here?
They're breaking free! They're attacking! Call out the army, the navy, the royal archers, but stop them!
Hey! Ow! Ouch! Cut it out, you guys! Come on, stop it!
Do you surrender, giants?
Okay, okay. We surrender.
What do we do now, Your Majesty?
Well, we must negotiate the terms of surrender. Send out the truce party.
Mark my words, we're making a big mistake coming out here alone.
Don't worry, Glum. I'll take care of that giant if he tries anything.
All right, all right. Now just remember, when we get there, I'll do the talking.
Well, now, this is more like it. A tiny truce team.
Giant, we want to talk to you.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Yeah. We have been sent by King Pomp to take you as our prisoners. Now come along quietly.
Look, fellas, tell your king that all we want to be is frip.
I know it. It's a trap.
Achoo!
That settles it. The giants can't be trusted. Open fire with the royal cannons!
No, wait! I only sneezed! Tag! Look out! Don't move, Tag. Let's see what they're up to.
Do you think he's...
I don't know.
You men should be ashamed of yourselves. A giant that handsome couldn't be bad.
Well, thank you, my little lady.
You can call me Flirtatia.
Oh! The giant's alive!
Lower the cannons!
Here, let me help you.
Did you see that, Bunko?
Yeah, they pointed the cannons back at themselves.
Now will you believe that we're friendly?
Yes. Well, then tell us, giant, if you are friendly, why did you invade us?
We didn't invade you, sir. Let me tell you what happened. And so you see, that's how we became washed up on your shores. Now I'm afraid we're hopelessly lost.
You're not lost at all.
We know where you are.
Sure, everybody knows that. You're in the kingdom of Lilliput.
Lilliput? This may be the lost island my father was searching for. Perhaps he's been washed ashore here too. And if he has, I must find him.
The lands beyond our city are very dangerous. They are inhabited by many fierce creatures.
Eager's right. Please don't leave, Gulliver.
I'm sorry, but I must go. Come on, Tag.
You know, maybe we should have gone with him.
Yeah, he's just a kid.
Well, I still think we'll all sleep a lot easier with him gone.
No luck so far. There's no trace that anyone survived the shipwreck. Maybe on the other side of those mountains. Come on, we've got to keep searching. A giant hawk. I wonder what he wants. Watch out, Tag! I guess he was just looking us over. Must be after something else.
The giant bird is coming. Prepare to defend the city.
Hey,
people must be in trouble. Come on, we're going back.
All right, you guys, hold it steady.
It'll never work.
Well, it looks like you guys need a little more practice. More cannons! More cannons! Bring up the cavalry!
Oh, no! The giant bird has taken the king!
It all started when I discovered wheels. You know, these wheel-shaped cheese-flavored snacks that taste so... cheese-flavored. Anyhow, I was fixing a tray of wheels when suddenly I saw a wheel stealer.
I am a wheel stealer, ha ha ha.
And he ate up all my wheels. So then I fixed a tray of flutes, these flute-shaped snacks with a butternut flavor. But when I turned my back, a flute snatcher got them.
The flute snatcher strikes again.
So then I bought crowns, crown-shaped snacks with a scrumptious corn-roasted flavor, and I was enjoying their corny crunchiness when I realized the character on the TV screen was in reality a crown grabber.
Crowns!
So that's it, friends. When you eat wheels, flutes, and crowns, you're gonna meet wheel stealers, flute snatchers, and crown grabbers. But beware, they're very sneaky and have all kinds of disguises. Why, there may be some in your house right now.
Not even you could reach the nest of the giant bird.
Perhaps you're right, but I'm going to try anyway.
Then we will go with you.
Yes!
No, you little people are going to stay right here where you belong. Now march. The hawk's nest is up there somewhere, Tag. Let's go. Discouraged him, and I hope he stays that way. Uh-oh. Looks like we've reached the end of the trail. We've got to get across that canyon, but how? Good thinking, Tag. That branch is just what we need. Now I'll have to get you across first. Only a few more feet to go. Now it's my turn. Well, that was close. There's the nest. Which path leads to it? Let's try the one on the left, Tag.
That's the wrong way.
Who said that?
We did, Gary.
I thought I told you to stay home.
But Gulliver.
But nothing. Now this is as far as you go. This time I'm going to make sure. Tag, you stay here and protect them. I'm taking a shortcut right up the side.
That's it, Gulliver. That's it. You're doing just great.
Don't listen to him, Gulliver. He's nothing but an amateur. Now pay close attention, and I'll guide you every step.
He'll never make it. He'll never make it.
Oh, yes, he will. He's so handsome. He's got to.
Well, it's about time you got here. What took you so long?
Well, it was quite a climb, Your Majesty.
Oh, I suppose you're right.
Now, we must hurry before the hawk returns. I hope you don't mind riding down in my pocket. never outrun him. Maybe we can toboggan down. Hang on, sir. Mountain Express shoving off. We've seen the last of that hawk, sir. Sir? Sir? King Pomp!
I'm down here, and I'm just fine, thanks to your bootstrap. And for performing such a courageous deed, I bestow on you, and Tag, the Royal Merit of Gratitude.
Thank you, sir.
And as long as you remain on this island, you may regard the Kingdom of Lilliput as your home.
Gulliver! Gulliver! Look what I found!
It's my father's watch. This truly is a great day.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go find it!
It's a fact, Snuff. 90% of all forest fires are caused by human carelessness.
Isn't there something we can do, Sniff?
Only what we've been doing. Get your equipment and follow me. Stop fires before they start.
Don't let this happen to Earth.
Is there intelligent life in space? Last week we discovered that we are not alone. With this film, the door to the universe opens for every Martian. First films of our successful Earth shot from the cameras on our orbiting spaceship. Despite the poisonous oxygen-laden atmosphere, signs of a civilization. And then the big news. There is life on Earth. Although no landing was attempted on this trip, it's obvious we've got a lot to learn from the Earthling. Now, first close-up shots of that Earthling. Here we see him at dinner, a carefully regulated meal, after which he takes shelter for the night. He needs his rest. As you will see, it's going to be a busy day. For most Earthlings, it appears to be all play and no work. Anything that stands in the way of the smooth, fast life is not tolerated for long. Loud honking and squawking brings a worker on the double. Earthling proceeds to prearranged gathering places. At first, our scientists were puzzled by this stately procession. The simple reason: they enjoy each other's company and have an almost compulsive desire to play elaborate games together. Occasionally, they stop to chat, but any lag in games and dancing brings a sharp response from briskly efficient social directors who never leave their posts. Furious fun and exhaustion. There's a steady run on spas and medical centers. Nor is the mind neglected. Education is everywhere. He spends a lot of time browsing in curiously designed libraries. Often connected to such libraries are audio-visual centers. From every angle and by every means, the Earthling is being conditioned. What is he learning? What is his ultimate purpose? It is here, in this retirement park, that the meaning of his joyous celebrations and feverish education becomes clear. The mature individual is now ready to make his essential contribution to his civilization. He instructs a worker to prepare him for his last act. He is now in proper shape to reproduce. Earthlings have done away with the stresses and untidiness of sex. The reproductive process takes place in three or four huge breeding centers. Although this process is shrouded in secrecy, our scientists believe that it must go something like this. Newborn Earthling, full grown, ready for a place in society. That such a highly developed civilization has not yet found a way to combat parasites. These pesky little creatures build huge hives or nests, which often block or slow down the orderly progress of the Earthling. However, the Earthling seems to have this matter in hand. The eradication of these pests is obviously a top priority job for the working class. And so we look forward to our first soft landing and direct contact with the fascinating Earthling. Well done, scientists of Mars.
Sure tears up the landscape.
Wow, super fast.
Groovy colors.
It appears that Dexter has secured a window for that stock car 150.
Keep watching.
Nearly nerfed itself on the straights.
Clearly very hot, as you say, but an unsafe vehicle.
Right. Dexter's poured cubic bucks into the engine, but ignored every safety factor.
Never get me to jockey those wheels.
Even his drivers have quit.
Boy, I'll bet old chicken Dexter is desperate for a driver.
What you doing?
Observing reconnaissance films.
Oh, say, when do I ever get to race for this club?
Artis, you know girls can't drive with the hot wheels.
And girls never took auto shop before either.
And that reminds me, use any more bobby pins on cars and you're going to flunk shop.
Why not? A bobby pin works as good as a cotter pin anyway. Boy, you don't appreciate me as a mechanic, as a driver, or even as a girl. Well, I know somebody who does.
Hot wheels! Hot wheels!
Hot Wheels!
Dexter, what is it you wanted to tell me?
Artie, I'm in trouble.
You are?
Yes, my no-good drivers. I had to fire them all.
Fire them?
Incompetent brutes. Not one with enough spirit to handle my new wheels.
Why tell me?
Because your fine driving has attracted my attention. Because those stupid, insensitive Hot Wheels don't appreciate you.
I said no bad-mouthing the wheels.
Hey, wait. I just want you to drive for the demons against the Hot Wheels.
I'm not that angry at them, Dexter.
But they did turn you down, didn't they?
Well, yes. All right, I'll drive on one condition. None of your tricks.
What tricks? Of course, to get into the demons, you'll have to pose as a boy.
Why not? Being a girl sure hasn't helped me.
Super is the finest stock car money can buy.
Drives that hot bucket, gotta want to drive awful bad.
Hey, not that way, you loon. She'll see you.
Oh, yeah. When I meet her, she's gotta be a little boy.
And after the race, Jack Wheeler's going to be the littlest boy in racing.
What a feeling! Like flying!
Why did you hold her back? The car can do another 20 miles an hour.
Once you get it fixed.
Fixed? The fastest car in this part of the country fixed?
It got kind of squirrely.
Maybe you want to drive girls' rules. You tricked me into believing you could drive good as a guy.
I'm better than a guy.
Ha! Bah!
All right, I'll push your old go machine to the limit.
Fine.
There, Kip, your work on that tuned header should add a few more horses.
Just a matter of solving some simple equations. Jack, Dexter's got himself a new driver.
So I hear.
Burning up the oval. Are you worried about losing the 150, Jack?
Yes. And about Dexter's new driver.
Feels funny.
Nonsense. Fits you like a glove, my dear.
I'm not your dear, and I'm only dressing like a boy so I can get to the race.
Of course, of course. We'll make this brief. To introduce our new driver, Artie.
Hi, fellas.
Where's he from?
All in favor, say aye.
Where'd he drive before?
The ayes have it. You practice some more, my dear, my boy, while we finish our business meeting. Okay, troublemakers, you just talked yourselves out of a free feed.
Just ribbing you, Dexie.
But we throw that female out of the club as soon as she waxes the Hot Wheels.
After the race, we unmask Ardeth as a girl who beat the Hot Wheels. And laugh Jack Wheeler right out of racing.
Great idea, Dex.
What's she doing? What's she doing?
He.
Yeah, he. What do you think you're doing out there?
Boy, whoever set this car up doesn't know very much.
What are you talking about?
A loose wheel bearing. That's what I'm talking about. Jack this baby up, boys.
There isn't time. They're already lining up for the start.
There's time. Yeah, just like I thought. A broken cotter pin.
So that's what made this wagon shake.
Well, Jack, artist makes do.
Last call to line up.
Come on, Artie, get moving.
Here's the final entry for Dexter's Demons.
That's Dexter's new boy.
Looks familiar.
You never saw him before.
Drivers will follow the pace car for the first lap. If a driver is not in position coming up to the starting line, you will have to go around again.
Dark's fast crew, I'll be in the lead before Artis gets out of the pit. Go!
Here he comes, here he comes! Can't you dum-dums go faster?
You don't like the service, do it yourself!
Don't argue! Please don't argue!
Okay, but keep him quiet.
Man, look at Wheeler go! This is your fault, mothering the car. Now get out there and stand on it.
Cool.
Hot Wheels, brand new.
Hot Wheels. For you. Amazing blazing Hot Wheels custom classics. Super future Hot Wheels show and go cars. Just like real Hot Wheels Grand Prix cars. Hot Wheels. Faster than you can see. See?
Alone.
Or in super action sets. The one and only Mattel Hot Wheels.
They're cool.
See all the great new Mattel toys now at your Mattel All Occasion Gift Center.
Groovy. That's the toasted oat taste of Cheerios. The energy breakfast with protein and vitamin B1 to help you feel groovy all morning long. Get in the Cheerios groove.
Feeling groovy. Just had my Cheerios. Groovy, groovy.
Catch that leprechaun. He's got Lucky Charms. They're magically delicious.
They're catching up. I'll take a boat ride with me Lucky Charms, the frosted oat cereal with sweet surprises. Hearts, moons, stars, clovers. See? Magically delicious. Oh, I'll make a motor.
Frosted Lucky Charms with sweet surprises.
Magically delicious.
Driver's license, young man.
Sure, officer, but what did I do wrong?
You were exceeding the speed limit.
I was?
You were. You were going 27 miles per hour in a 25-mile zone.
He acted like I was really standing on it. Like, I mean, after all, 2 miles an hour over the speed limit. And what he said, believe me, you wouldn't believe what he said.
What'd he say? What'd he say?
I'll tell you what I said. I said this place is a breeding ground for trouble, for law-breaking hot rodders. Fast kids, fast cars. That's what I said.
Just a minute, officer.
O'Flaherty. Timothy O'Flaherty.
I'm pleased to meet you. You're new to the police force here, aren't you?
To the Metro City farce, I am. But I've been a policeman better than 20 years, except for 6 months out mending a broken leg. I was chasing a hot rod kid over 100 miles an hour in one of these bombs. There was an accident. I rolled over and he got away scot-free. But he's the last one that's going to get away. I'm going to watch you kids like a hawk. You better behave or you'll be out of business because I don't like hot rodders.
All I can say is, man, oh man, wait till Sergeant Timothy O'Flaherty runs into Dexter's demons.
Oh, boy.
How long are we going to keep this up, Dexter?
Until we find him or he finds us. Now, the way I heard it, O'Flaherty really read out the Hot Wheels, and he's after anybody with a set of mags or slicks.
And you're looking for him? I don't get it.
You will. And that's him over there. Now, you let me do the talking.
I still don't get it. He's on us.
And that's exactly where I want him to be. Sergeant O'Flaherty. Good afternoon, officer.
Good afternoon.
I'm Dexter Carter, and I noticed that you were following me. Now, I certainly hope I wasn't doing anything wrong.
No, I can't say you were. Who owns all these hot rods?
They belong to some friends of mine. We sort of use this place to work on our cars and conduct meetings on the merits of safe driving and the responsibility of being permitted to have a driver's license and general rules of courtesy on the streets and highways. That sort of thing, officer.
Well, no, that sounds very interesting.
Yes, indeed. We believe in safety and courtesy at all times. Of course, there are some who... Oh, well, not all young people in this town believe as we do. I mean, well, like that one club. They call themselves Hot Wheels. You know about them, of course.
Indeed, I do.
We've asked them to attend some of our meetings, but... By the way, we're having a meeting right now if you'd like to sit in and see for yourself.
Well, I think I'll just do that. I can only spare a few minutes, but let's see what you're up to.
It'll be a few minutes well spent, I assure you. Now, to continue from last week, when you see other kids speeding or possibly breaking the law, stop them if you can and explain to them. And if you ever see anyone dragging or racing, except on a designated drag strip or raceway, take their number and report them to the police. Now, is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, Dexter. Gotcha.
All right. That's all for today. And I'll let you know when we have our next meeting. So long, fellas. And drive carefully.
You're doing a fine thing here, young man. I'm proud of you.
Well, thank you very much, Officer O'Flaherty.
I'll tell you one thing. Those Hot Wheels, as they call themselves, could certainly learn something if you could ever get them to come here.
As I told you, I tried, but...
Well, I've got to be going. Keep up the good work.
You ought to be an actor.
You still having that drag tonight?
Why not? 8:00. The old farm road south of town.
Yeah, like we'll tear up the landscape.
Hi, Mr. Warren. What brings you here?
I heard something in school today I thought you should know about.
What's that?
I heard there's going to be a drag race tonight.
Dexter's demons, I'll bet.
We ought to stop them before they get into trouble.
Well, I think that's a fine thing to do. Who knows? Dexter might even appreciate it.
Okay, here's what we do. Cover every possible place. Whoever finds them, try and stop them. If they refuse, then you have no choice but to call in the police.
That's rather tough, isn't it?
Well, it's better than somebody maybe getting killed. Mickey, you go with Ardeth and cover the north side.
Okay.
Kip, you and Tank split and cover the central section.
Right.
Janet and I will cover the area south of town. Now watch it, because we're trying to prevent trouble, not start it. You understand?
Yeah.
Okay, let's move.
Where are we going?
The county just regraded the old farm road south of town.
Well, that'd be a groovy place for a drag, but a dirt road. It could also be a bad scene.
That's what I was thinking.
Someone's following us.
Yeah, I know.
Man, that Mags is pouring it off.
Yeah, he's really bombing it. Come on, let's light. I'll take you on next.
Me against you?
You chicken?
Are you kidding? Let's roll.
Who invited you?
Nobody, but if you know what's good for you, you'll bust this up and split out of here before...
All right, out of here, you stay right where you are, and especially you.
Dig, it's the man.
Stop. You do as I say. Don't move from this spot until I get back.
All right, let's bomb out of here. Now.
This is really a bad scene.
You're telling me?
What are you doing?
Going after Sergeant O'Flaherty. Try and explain. Help me. We gotta get him to a hospital. He's hurt. Hurt bad.
Use my belt. Make a tourniquet for his arm. He's bleeding.
Think he's going to make it?
He'll be all right.
Really a nice
I hope
guy.
He pulls out of it.
Who was it that brought him in?
That is, we did.
You got him here just in time. He is conscious now, and he's going to be all right.
Oh, thank goodness.
Could we talk to him? I'd like to, well, sort of explain what...
I don't think that's necessary. He knows what he needs to know.
What's that?
That the Hot Wheels saved his life.
That Dexter Carter and his bunch are getting their driver's licenses suspended.
For this safe driving school you Hot Wheels run here, well, it's commendable. I'd like to come by from time to time, if you don't mind, that is.
You're welcome anytime, Sergeant.
Well, thank you, Jack. I guess everybody makes a mistake in judgment now and then. I know I did. But I guess maybe that just proves cops are human after all.
What are you talking about?
A loose wheel bearing. That's what I'm talking about. Jack this baby up, boys.
There isn't time. They're already lining up for the start.
There's time. Yeah, just like I thought. A broken cotter pin.
So that's what made this wagon shake.
Well, Jack, artist makes do.
Last call to line up.
Come on, Artie. Get moving.
Here's the final entrance for Dexter's Demons.
That's Dexter's new boy.
Looks familiar.
You never saw him before.
Drivers will follow the pace car for the first lap. If a driver is not in position coming up to the starting line, you will have to go around again.
What do you think?
Sure tears up the landscape.
Wow, super fast.
Groovy colors.
It appears that Dexter has secured a winner for that stock car 150.
Keep watching.
But squirrely.
Nearly nerfed itself on the straights.
Clearly very hot, as you say, but an unsafe vehicle.
Right. Dexter's poured cubic bucks into the engine, but ignored every safety factor.
Never get me to jockey those wheels.
Even his drivers have quit.
Boy, I'll bet old chicken Dexter is desperate for a driver.
What you doing?
Observing reconnaissance films.
Oh, say, when do I ever get to race for this club?
Artis, you know girls can't drive for the Hot Wheels.
And girls never took auto shop before either.
And that reminds me, use any more bobby pins on cars and you're going to flunk shop.
Why not? A bobby pin works as good as a cotter pin anyway. Boy, you don't appreciate me as a mechanic, as a driver, or even as a girl.
Because those stupid, insensitive Hot Wheels don't appreciate you.
I said no bad-mouthing the wheels.
Hey, wait. I just want you to drive for the Demons against the Hot Wheels.
I'm not that angry at them, Dexter.
But they did turn you down, didn't they?
Well, yes. All right, I'll drive on one condition. None of your tricks.
What tricks? Of course, to get into the Demons, you'll have to pose as a boy.
Why not? Being a girl sure hasn't helped me.
Wow!
The Dexter Super is the finest stock car money can buy.
Drives that hot bucket, gotta want to drive awful bad.
Hey, not that way, you loon. She'll see you.
Oh, yeah. When I meet her, she's gotta be a little boy.
And after the race, Jack Wheeler's going to be the littlest boy in racing.
What a feeling! Like flying!
Why did you hold her back? The car can do another 20 miles an hour.
Once... Well, I know somebody who does.
Hot Wheels! Hot Wheels!
Dexter, what is it you wanted to tell me?
Artie, I'm in trouble.
You are?
Yes, my no-good drivers. I had to fire them all.
Fire them?
Incompetent brutes. Not one with enough spirit to handle my new wheels.
Why tell me?
Because your fine driving has attracted my attention.
You get it fixed.
Fixed? The fastest car in this part of the country fixed?
It got kind of squirrely.
Maybe you want to drive girls' rules. You tricked me into believing you could drive good as a guy.
I'm better than a guy.
Bah!
All right, I'll push your old go machine to the limit.
Fine.
There, Kip, your work on that tuned header should add a few more horses.
Just a matter of solving some simple equations.
Jack, Dexter's got himself a new driver.
So I hear.
Burning up the oval.
Are you worried about losing the 150, Jack?
Yes. And about Dexter's new driver.
Feels funny.
Nonsense. Fits you like a glove, my dear.
I'm not your dear, and I'm only dressing like a boy so I can get to the race.
Of course, of course. We'll make this brief. To introduce our new driver, Artie.
Aye, fellas.
Where's he from?
All in favor, say aye.
Where'd he drive before?
The ayes have it. You practice some more, my dear, my boy, while we finish our business meeting. Okay, troublemakers, you just talked yourselves out of a free feed.
Just ribbing you, Dexie.
Well, we throw that female out of the club as soon as she waxes the Hot Wheels.
After the race, we unmask Ardeth as a girl who beat the Hot Wheels. And laugh Jack Wheeler right out of racing.
Great idea, Dex.